The referee, Steve Yuschek. The umpire, John Davidson. The head linesman, Don Capua. The line judge, Derek Bowers. Field judge, Brad Van Bark. The side judge, Phil Laurie. And the back judge, Randy McAnally. And we're about set to go as Tim Duncan will be kicking off from left to right. Mark Matthew just said on an intercom, the wind is not a factor at this moment. And Corey Cowens will play, at least on the special teams here. He has been injured most of the week.
Right, I noticed he warmed up with the defense, Bob. Isn't that the same referee that penalized Oklahoma the other night when Kansas State and Nebraska were playing?
That's exactly where I believe it is. Paul McClendon is back deep, and we're underway. The final home game. Boy, Tim Duncan plants it over the head of Paul McClendon into the end zone. And the Texas Tech Red Raiders will begin first down 10 yards to go from their own 20-yard line. So the Sooners got in the end zone. That's what Tim Duncan wanted to do, I'm sure, to start things off, Merv. And let's see what the Sooner defense can do.
I think that's one of the critical things you look for in a kicker, Bob, is a guy that can put it in the end zone. It's so much better than having to run down there and make a tackle on the kickoff.
Cliff Kingsbury, 6'4", 200-pound sophomore, 61.3% of his passes have been completed. Shad Williams at running back, Ricky Williams at running back, and Darrell Jones, wide receiver, along with Tim Baker. And no tight end here. Two wide receivers to both sides. Stephen fakes the blitz. They are blitzing. Kingsbury raises up. Quick pass. Juggled. Almost intercepted at the 24. Wes Welker, who started at wide receiver. He's from Heritage Hall in Oklahoma City. He fumbled the ball as he was coming across on a very short route, and he couldn't quite hold on. The ball went free and was almost intercepted before it hit the ground by Torrance Marshall, but not, and it's second and 10 from the 20.
That's typical of a lot of passes they throw. They're only 2 and 3 yards deep.
In the shotgun formation again, Kingsbury is back. Single tailback is Ricky Williams to his left. Three wide receivers right and one to the left. Kingsbury on the naked reverse to keep around the left side. Gets upfield, gets about 2 or 3 yards. Heineke hit him along with Derek Strait, who hit him first. Kingsbury had to stop to try to avoid a tackler, and that's when the Sooners pursued well. Pickup of only 2, 3rd and 8.
That might be a special maneuver that Coach Leach has put in. It didn't look like he had any intention of really trying to find a receiver, did it?
No, it didn't. Just running to the left, and everybody else went to the right. Two wide receivers right and two to the left. That's a third down comes up for the first time. They're 39% on third down completions, Texas Tech is this season. Their opponents are 28%. Here's the snap from the shotgun. Kingsbury back to pass. Here's a flat pass caught behind the line by Ricky Williams. He's hit hard and loses a yard as he was nailed at the 21. Roy Williams buckled up Ricky Williams. And a one-yard loss back to the 21. So the Sooners get them three and out, and they'll go on the offense, hopefully, after this punt from Texas Tech. And back is J.T. Thatcher to receive. That's pretty impressive defensive.
Well, it was. It's a very conservative beginning for the Red Raiders. You know, they never threw the ball downfield, never threw anything difficult at all.
It's the Clinton, the Great House, back to kick, 38.9 yards per punt. The snap was on the money. Sooners have the return on it, appears. J.T. Thatcher catches it at the 41 in Oklahoma territory, up to the 50 in the Tech territory, and then is ridden down at the 48-yard line. And tackle made by Zeno McCoy, who is a defensive linebacker by trade. 38-yard punt, 11-yard return, and the Sooners have their first possession in Texas Tech territory, and that's a good sign.
That's why you defer, Bob. Take advantage of the elements, hopefully, and have your defense go out and 1, 2, 3 and send them back to the bench and get the ball around midfield. And so far, that's exactly what the Sooners were hoped for.
Ball is at the Texas Tech 48, first and 10. Sooners lost by 10 points to this team a year ago. It was the final game of the year. Two wide receivers to the left and two to the right. Savage in motion from right to left. The give to Savage on end around the left side. Cuts at the 46, the 45, 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, 15 to the 10, to the 5. He stepped out of bounds. Let's see where they spy. At the 16-yard line, he stepped out of bounds. That's that end around. They simply hand off to him and sweep, and he picks up 32 yards from the 48 to the 16. What a play.
Really a good call. It looked like Tech was in a front where they planned to drop a lot of people off and defend on the first play. The Sooners normally throw on the first play, and it really set up well for them.
That's his seventh carry of the year, and he got 32 yards, Savage did, down to the Texas Tech 16. First down 10, three wide receivers to the right. Quentin Griffin is the only back behind Hype, who's under center. Gets to Griffin, right side, 15 to the 10, and maybe to the 9. A nice pickup of 7. Howard Duncan with the block on the left side. And the tackle made on the play by John Norman, who is playing for Texas Tech.
The two fronts they've lined up in the first two plays, Bob, are they're almost challenging the Sooners to rush the football. They really are. There's only one linebacker. The two outside backers are lined up very wide, and that's surprising down inside the 20-yard line.
A pick up there from the 16 to the 9, 7 yards gain, so it's second down and three at the Tech 9-yard line. Sooners have three wide receivers right and one left hand to Griffin hitting the backfield this time. Boy, they clobbered him that time. Just immediately, Dorian Pitts, the outside linebacker, was blitzing. He got to Griffin before he could take a step, and it's a loss of the play of a couple of yards. Let's see where they put the ball down. The line of scrimmage was the 9, and they put it at the 11. So it's a third down play and 5 from the 11.
I think that Scott Kempnick over here on the right side must have just gone to sleep on that play and was involved with the tight end and trying to work on the defensive end and didn't see the blitz. That wasn't that complicated maneuver.
Two wide receivers left, Walfolk and Savage from the shotgun this time for the first time. Slightly in motion is Savage back to 5, and a flag is thrown. It was a late flag. Let's go down to Mark Matthew and see if he saw anything on that. Mark?
Might have been a little bit of a face mask down here, Bob. I don't know if that's the call or not, but the tackle made by 51 out there, and it was a late one.
Whoa.
No, they say pushing or something or interference on OU is the indication.
Well, it was a late flag, Merv. I wonder if it was on the receiver or whether it was somebody else that pushed.
I don't know. It's very difficult to say. The position of the official over there would indicate not anything at the line of scrimmage.
So Savage is who it was called on, I think. 15-yard penalty. Wow, that instead of the ball being at the 5 first and goal, it's back at the 26-yard line, and a third down play and 20 for the Sooners from the Texas Tech 26. They need to get to the 6 for the first down.
Boy, that's huge, Bob. Instead of a first down at this 5-yard line, here we are back here looking at a ton of yards.
From the 26, Heupel in the shotgun. Three wide receivers left and one to the right. No score early in this game. Heupel back to pass. He lobs a screen pass caught by Griffin at the 27, the 20, down to the 15-yard line, down to the 10-yard line. And maybe they didn't quite get to the 10. They mark it at the 11. Brought down by Chris Koshorek, who is the left tackle from Caldwell, Texas, and Derek Briggs helped out. So the Sooners sent in the kicking unit. Try the field goal. This ball is at the 11. Went from the 26 to the 11, and that's a 15-yard pickup, but they needed 20. 28-yard field goal attempt. He's 5 of 6 from this distance, and Duncan is 10 of 16 on the year. A little angle to the right. Holding will be Patrick Fletcher. Snap. Ball down. Kick in the air, blocked, it's free, picked up by Texas Tech, now lateral, running upfield to the 20, 25, Briggs to the 30, and Briggs gets by a tackler at the 35, cuts upfield, gets to the 40-yard line, the 45-yard line. And so the blocked field goal, the Sooners' third blocked kicking situation in 2 weeks, gives the momentum right back to Texas Tech. The Sooners, it appeared for a moment, would have penalized for pass interference, got a 15-yard pickup, but then a blocked field goal attempt. And the ball is at the 45 in Tech territory. How about that? Wow.
Oh, I tell you, that's two horrible mistakes.
30-yard return on the blocked field goal.
It did look like a very low kick. I didn't see anybody break through. But that's just, instead of first down at the 5, now we're looking at this. And it's just two errors. That's what we talked about. Could
shovel
not happen.
Shovel passes. Kingsbury gets the ball off of missed tackle at the 48 to the 50 down to Oklahoma's 45. Shad Williams got the shovel pass, a missed tackle at about the line of scrimmage, and Shad Williams finally got it, was finally tackled rather by J.T. Thatcher, but not before it picked up a little over 10 yards. So it's a first down for Texas Tech, their first of the year. They have the momentum and the ball just downfield from the Oklahoma 45, their first trip in Oklahoma territory. Shotgun again. Kingsbury is the quarterback. He operates mostly out of the shotgun. Back to pass, looks to his right, fires, caught. And a short gain to the 41, maybe. Tim Baker makes the catch. He caught four passes against Oklahoma a year ago. He's their leading receiver. That's his 64th catch of the year, as we call it, to the 41, a 4-yard pickup.
They're using a no huddle out here now, Bob, in an effort to keep the Sooners maybe from calling or substituting like they would like to.
Three wide receivers to the left, one to the right, man in motion. So it's an empty backfield. Kingsbury gets the exchange, looks in the flat, plays the throws, caught at the 45 to the 40, tackled inside the 40 at the 38, maybe the 37. Shad Williams, Shad from Andrews, Texas, the leading rusher in Class 4A in high school. He was a running back, and the tackle made by Torrance Marshall. They'll place the ball down at the 37, a pickup from the 41 to the 37, 4 yards picked up, third down play, and 2. Under center is Kingsbury this time, one back behind him. is Sean Williams, man in motion from left to right. Gift to Welker. Welker over the right side. He's hit hard. And I don't know whether he made the first down or not. It's very, very close at the area. What do you think, Merv?
It looks like it's a little short from where we sit. We've got a pretty good look at it here. I think it's very important that the defense right now can keep their pose, keep their composure. They've had some bad things happen, not necessarily to them, but to the offense and the kicking game. And it looks like that they have. Looks like they're out there not panicking at all. And I think that's important right now, just to go ahead and let Tech make their little burst here.
It's just about a foot short, and it'll be a fourth down play, and I would imagine Texas Tech will go for it in the area of the 35-yard line, Oklahoma Territory.
They would, at this point, I think, want to be careful about being caused to jump offside, Bob, because certainly Coach Leach had a lot of success with that last year.
9:40 to go first quarter, no score. And next, here we go, Texas Tech's going for it under center Kingsbury. Needs about a foot for the first down. Now he backs out of there. He'll be changing the play. Now he gets back under center. Gets the exchange. And quarterback sneak, I think he made it. Looked like he had a surge that got him at least that foot. And so Texas Tech has their second first down in Oklahoma Territory. We would like to remind all fans that tomorrow night's that the basketball game tomorrow night will be on KRXO in the Oklahoma City area. That'll be tonight. We said the word tomorrow. We made a mistake. It's tonight. And we'll be there, Lord willing, to broadcast the game for you. And in the Oklahoma City area, it'll be on KRXO. It's first down for Texas Tech at the 34-yard line in Oklahoma Territory. Kingsbury again in the shotgun. No score early in this one. Gets the snap. Looks to his right. Now looks left. Bing Rush throws a pass. Caught. Ricky Williams at the 33 to the 30. Down to the 29-yard line. Torrance Marshall on the stop. Again from the 34 down to the 29. A 5-yard pickup on the screen pass left. And the little short dink pass is working here currently for Texas Tech.
You got to be careful and not get impatient on those, Bob. You got to just go ahead and make good tackles and hope you can bat one up in the air here in a minute.
At the 29-yard line, it's second down play and 5 yards to go for Texas Tech at the Oklahoma 29. Shotgun formation, two wide receivers right, one to the left. Handoff on the end around. Ricky Williams and the hit in the backfield. Cordy Heineke gets him for a loss of about 3, maybe 4. I'm sorry, that's Barry Holloman rather than Heineke. It was 99 rather than 89. Barry Holloman's number 99. Got into the backfield and turned it in, and a loss on the play from the 29 back to 33. That's a big play for Barry Holloman.
It really was. I think they had a twist stunt between he and the end, so his course carried him to the outside, and he alertly saw it and stayed out there.
Third down play, needing to go to the 24. They have the ball for 33. 9 yards to go. 0-3 on third down conversions. Kingsbury in the shotgun. Sooners are showing blitz. They do blitz. Kingsbury back to pass. Fires a pass. Caught. First down at the 22 and tackled immediately. Great protection, and Tim Baker made the catch on a bullet pass from Kingsbury. They beat the blitz and pick up the first down and keep their drive alive in between the 20 and 21 in Sooner territory. Picked up about 13 yards on that play.
That was very good protection considering the blitz. They gave him plenty of time to hit a pass that he could get his first down with.
Third first down. The ball is at the Oklahoma 20, just upfield from it. No score early first period. 7:52 to go. Kingsbury under center. Backs up. Five-step drop. Throws it down the middle. Deflected. Intercepted at the 16. That's Thatcher to the 20. 25, 30. 35, 40. 45, 50. Down the near sideline. 40. 35, 30. 25, 20. 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Oklahoma. JT Thatcher. Seventh first. Interception return. His seventh of the year. And fifth as a team as far as touchdowns off interception. How about that?
What did I say about being patient until you can bat one up in the air, Bob?
I think he intercepted at the 16. We'll check with Jerry McLemore. 84-yard return tipped, I believe, by Barry Holloman, who made two big plays then in a row. Holloman threw that point at the south end zone. Sooners up 6-0. Ball down, kick in the air. This one's good. As perfect again with his extra points is Tim Duncan on the air. He is absolutely perfect. Has never missed this year. I think that's his 58th extra point of the year. Timeout, 7-0 Sooners. 7:35 to go first quarter. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network.
Tim Duncan to kick off for the Sooners. Deep for Texas Tech is Paul McClendon, Wes Welker, and number 82, Carlos Francis.
On top by the score of 7-0. Here is the kickoff. Duncan line drives this one, and it's into the end zone. Just as effective as a high ball that drifts down there. It goes skipping through the end zone. The ball brought out to the 20. First down, 10 yards to go for Texas Tech from their own 20 in their third possession.
I think that's a great series for the defense. They did make a couple of first downs. They had to go to fourth down and short once, but they stayed in there. They kept their poise. They put good pressure on Kingsbury. They got near him. They hit him after the throw a couple of times. I just think that was an outstanding first series for our defense.
Kingsbury now in the shotgun from the Texas Tech 20. Running backs are Shaud Williams and James Easterling now. From the shotgun, two wide receivers right and one to the left. Kingsbury got a short drop after, of course, he's in that shotgun. Nice big rush, and he's sacked. It's Ramon Richardson who broke through and makes the tackle. Ramon Richardson from Broken Arrow. He's playing right tackle where Barry Holland was. That position has made three big plays in a row.
Well, they really have, and part of it was the rush by Cody. He was in on the interception for the touchdown, and he was over here, and he forced the quarterback to step up into the pocket where Ramon was.
A loss of five. That's the fourth sack of the year for Ramon Richardson. Ball is at the 15 after the five-yard loss, and it's second and 15 for Texas Tech. Under center is Kingsbury. Raise up, quick pass, screen pass caught behind the line at the 50. Welker with a great run. Upfield, he breaks to 25, 30, 35, 40. They might catch him. Yes, they do. Ante Jones from behind gets him. Welker, who's from Heritage Hall, made the catch in the flat on the near side, broke to the middle, and looked for the moment like he might break it and go all the way. But Ante Jones, whom Coach Stoops told me this week's probably the fastest player on the Sooner team, caught up to him and tackled him at the Oklahoma 41-yard line. 44 yards picked up.
The missed tackles right there after he caught the pass. We had three defenders all around him, and had a missed tackle on the man coming from the inside.
That's the fourth first down for Texas Tech at the Oklahoma 41-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Kingsbury may be changing the play. Under center now. Sooners show blitz. Turns around, hands off to his running back. He's tripped out, does a somersault. Shaud Williams was hit hard by Rocky Kalmus. Said, how do you do? And flipped him a complete somersault. But the gain from the 41 to the 37, he picked up four on the play. Second down, six for Texas Tech there. Again, no huddle here. The no huddle offense. Two, three wide receivers left and one to the right. No tight end. They rarely use a tight end. Kingsbury gets the snap. Back to pass. He looks. Good protection. Throws in the flat. Caught at the 37. Shaun Williams makes the catch. Catching the ball. And Derek Strait on the tackle. A short gain there as well from the 37 to the 34-yard line. A pickup of three. And it brings up a third down and three for Texas Tech. Here's a big third down situation.
What you got to do on those short passes, make good tackles. They failed to do that while ago on Welker. It was not a deep pass, but the missed tackles allowed it to be a deep completion.
One of three on third down conversions. Kingsbury again in the shotgun. The center is Toby Cecil. And the Sooners now showing blitz. They have actually 11 men within 5 yards of the line of scrimmage. And here comes a full blitz. Kingsbury lobs it high downfield and caught, but out of bounds. It was caught by Derek Norris, but the Sooners had a full blitz on that time. Kingsbury just got the exchange and fired it high, so that worked beautifully defensively, and it brings up a fourth down play for the Red Raiders at the Oklahoma 34. They need 3 yards. They're thinking about going for it, or will they try a field goal?
They'll go for it. Coach Leach likes to go for it on fourth down. What have they got to lose today? Let's roll the dice. In their mind, I think we'll see them go for fourth down more than once.
They're 40% on fourth down conversions this year. Here we go, shotgun, three wide receivers left and one to the right. Kingsbury, back to pass, he looks, short pass, incomplete. Sooners get it on the, it's broken up by Roy Williams as it was thrown into a crowd intended for Ricky Williams. It was a low pass, but right in the middle of the field in a very short pass, Roy Williams knocked it away. So timeout on the field as the ball goes over on downs to Oklahoma. Sooners lead at 7-0, 5:13 to go first quarter. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. Merv, it's interesting to note that we have 5 minutes, a little bit more than that, to go in the first period. Sooners have only run about six offensive plays, but they lead 7-0. Here's Heupel, passes in the flat, caught Mackey at the 29-30, 35-40, and about an 8-yard, 9-yard pickup up to the 43-yard line. Line of scrimmage was the 34 and gets to the 43-yard line. So it's second down, a yard to go for Oklahoma at the 43. Tackle made by Paul McClendon and Mark Washington. A couple of extra safeties in there as Tech has five defensive backs.
Second and one, that's a little surprising. I think, though, again, they're going to try to defend a little more like we saw last week against A&M.
All right, let's see. We have the shotgun formation on the second one. Heupel hands the ball off. Draw play to Griffin. He's over the right side and is short of the first down. Very, very close to the first down, but appears, well, he may have it. We'll have to check it out. Tackle by Koshurek, the left tackle. And let's see. They didn't get a real good spot. Maybe no gain on the play. It'll be third down and about a half yard to go in the area of the Oklahoma 43-yard line. Under center, Heupel, he'll do the quarterback sneak on the quick snap and easily got the first down. Flag on the far side. I don't know whether the Sooners were set or not, Murph.
I think they were. I watched that particularly because I expected him to run it quickly, and it looks like that way the Tech's middle linebacker had his back to the football when it was snapped.
All right, here is Mr. Steve Juszczyk to tell us about it. So it's you heard what he said. It's going to move the ball back from the 43 down back to the 38 and a half. And it brings up a third down play. And the Sooners are shooting themselves in the foot here early.
Well, they really
on
have.
Offense.
Third down penalties, this is the second time in a row they failed to overcome the first time. Let's hope that they can here.
At about the almost the 39-yard line is where it is. Third down play. Wide receivers deployed left and right. And now Josh Heupel may be changing the play with 3:53 to go in the first period. They're showing blitz. Back to pass, Heupel fires. It's deflected. Knocked down on the play, and it'll be punt time in the Valley. The offense has not gotten on track. They had a 32-yard run to Savage on the first play from scrimmage. Other than that, pass interference, even though they had the ball, and a blocked field goal, so it's not been good. That was special teams.
Well, those two penalty downs, Bob, they had made the first down in both instances and had it called back with a penalty.
So here's the punting situation, and it's Jeff Ferguson, who had two punts blocked a week ago. He's averaging 44.9 yards per kick. Back is Wes Welker. He is the deep back. Keep for Texas Tech. Now let's see. There we go. Snap is back. Here's the kick. High kick. Beautiful kick with the win. And Welker takes it at the 25, and he's hit hard as he gets about 2 yards up to the 29. Andre Wolfolk, who's a terrific special teams player. Timeout after the 36-yard punt, 2-yard return. It'll be at the Texas Tech 29 when we have time back in. 3:36 to go first period, 7-0 Sooners. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. Have played well on offense with four first downs, and believe it or not, the Sooners have zero. Well, they have one first down, beg your pardon. One first down, but they lead at 7-0 on that 84-yard pass interception return, JT Thatcher. All right, from the 29-yard line, Tech territory, shotgun formation, Kingsbury with the blitz on, rolls to his right, throws a pass, has to throw it away. He was under heavy pressure that time as Eric Fernander, the defensive end, came across the field from his right. And the quarterback Kingsbury just had to throw it away, Merv.
I think that's, again, another very good play by the defense. We need to make Kingsbury aware that there is going to be a rush at times and have it on his mind.
Again, the no huddler. Excuse me, Merv.
No, I think
it's...
It's
the ninja formation now for...
Coach Stoops just wants to see what's there.
So the Sooners have practiced against this, Coach Stoops told me. Let's see what happens. Here is Kingsbury. Quick pass is caught. Welker at the 27-30. He's tripped up at the 33 and falls forward. Michael Thompson tripped him up. You have to get rid of the ball in a hurry from that ninja formation because you're outnumbered where the quarterback is. Roy Williams overran the play a little bit, it appears. The gain goes as they mark it at 6 yards to the 35s. No huddle again. It's third and four. And on third downs, they're one of four. This is a shotgun with running back to either side. Fake handoff to running back. Back to pass the ball. Kingsbury throws. Knocked away on a fine defensive play. And flags come down. Ante Jones reached over Baker. And the flags come down. It'll be pass interference, apparently, on the Sooners.
The coaches are saying it's tipped. I don't know whether they'll get a vote or not.
And let's see, Barry Holloman says he tipped it. He tipped one earlier, and that resulted in the interception return. And now let's see what the officials rule. They're going to call pass interference.
Pass interference on a defense. Spot foul. Automatic first down.
So the Sooners have had a pass interference on their offense, on the wide receiver when they had the ball, and a pass interference on the defense now, and it's a first down, number 5 for Texas Tech, at their own 47-yard line. First down and 10 yards to go for the Red Raiders. Under center is Kingsbury, Cliff Kingsbury from Moonburnville, Texas, which is near the San Antonio area. Under center, here's the handoff. Ricky Williams going to his left, buckled up by Roy Williams after he got a yard, maybe two, to the 49. Ricky Williams, of course, as a freshman, was all-world. He was injured and laid out a year, and this offense that Coach Leach has at Texas Tech does not lend itself to a running game. He had only 454 yards coming in to this game, Ricky Williams. Got a couple. Second down, 8 from the 49 in Tech territory. Now back to the shotgun. 3 wide receivers left and a man in motion to the left. So you got 4 wide receivers to the left and 1 to the right. Here's a flat pass.
Screen pass.
It's a lateral and a pass, and it's caught. And missing a tackle at the Oklahoma 42 and out of bounds inside the 40 at the 38 is the Texas Tech Red Raider Cole Roberts, who made the catch. So the pass was lateraled back to Mickey Peters, who is a former quarterback. He was converted to a wide receiver this year, and he threw the pass downfield to Cole Roberts, who made the catch, and the game goes from the Texas Tech 49, about 13 yards down to the Oklahoma 38-yard line, where the 6th first down for Texas Tech. Oklahoma leads it 7-0. Texas had the ball most of the time. Pass in the flat, caught by Welker at the 38. He's tackled across the 35, the 33-yard line by Ante Jones. Inside screen again, it went to Welker on the far side. He got outside and got the ball down to the 33 from the 38. 5 yards picked up. So it'll be a second down play and 5 for Texas Tech. They're moving the ball. They started this drive after the Sooners punted from their own 29. Ball at the Oklahoma 33. Shotgun formation. 2 wide receivers left and 2 to the right. Kingsbury from the shotgun. Back to pass. He looked. Good protection. Throws. Caught at the 32. And Baker makes the catch, and he hits the ground about the time he got the ball, as Roy Williams really hit him hard. And it'll be a gain of about a yard, maybe 2. It was a crossing pattern. Roy Williams hit the receiver just the instant the ball got there. They'll put it at the 31-yard line between the 31 and 32. Third down play. And need to go to the 28 for the first down. So about 3.5 yards to go. 1 of 4 on third down conversions. Kingsbury back to pass. Throws in the flat. Caught by Ricky Williams. Nothing there for him as he catches it in the far side. Tripped up again by Roy Williams. And the play ends at the 31-yard line. So a gain of about a yard and brings a fourth down play. Needing to go from the 31 to the 28 for the first down. Red Raiders will go for it on fourth down. This is the third time they've gone for it on fourth down. Yeah. That's unusual.
It's not for Coach Leach, really, especially if he's an underdog. I think that he's going to try to, you know, make something happen.
All right, the Sooner crowd gets into the act.
They just got to be careful about being thrown offside.
And the Red Raiders will call a timeout to talk it over. So we will take a break with 43 seconds to go in the first period. Oklahoma leads Texas Tech 7-0. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. All right, first down. It's a shotgun formation. 3 wide receivers left, 1 to the right. Kingsbury lobs a pass and almost intercepted by Sanger. And
you want to drop that one, Bob.
Well, he did drop it, and that's fortunate because he would have probably been tackled down around the 15-yard line. It was intended for Baker. So for the second time out of 3 tries on fourth down, Texas Tech fails, and the second time in a row, and the Sooners will take over on downs, trying to get something started on offense. And we're in the first period with 39 seconds to go, and Oklahoma has run 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7 plays in the entire first quarter on offense.
Well, they've had 2 possessions, the 2 third down penalties brought back first down plays. That's their only problem.
Heupel in the shotgun from the Oklahoma 31. Gets the snap. He's back to pass. He looks. He throws in the flat. It's incomplete at the 30-yard line. Quentin Griffin was the lad for whom the pass was intended. Looked as though he might have been able to catch it, but thrown a little bit in front of him at the 30. He was running away from the ball. Second down and 10 at the 31. In other words, running laterally away from the ball. Here is Josh Norman checking into the OU lineup in place of Seth Luttrell, who's wearing 42 today in honor of his Father Jimmy Luttrell, who wore that number when he was a starting fullback at OU. Three wide receivers to the right and one to the left. That's Fagan left. That's the short side of the field to the left. They're really up on the line of scrimmage, showing blitz. Heupel back to pass. He looks. He throws. Caught by Josh Norman, and he loses his balance and trips as he tries to make a cut at the 32. So a gain of only a yard, and the Sooners face suddenly third down and nine from their own 32. Here is Fagan checking into the Oklahoma lineup. Or rather, I beg your pardon, that's Luttrell checking in, replacing Norman. Now we got it. And then Fagan goes wide left. That's a shotgun formation from the 32. Need to get to the 41 in Sooner territory for the first down. Oklahoma has one first down, but they have a touchdown. Texas Tech does not have any, and they didn't get the playoff before the first quarter runs out. That's the end of period number one. Oklahoma 7, Texas Tech.
Beginning the second quarter of play, third and nine for the Sooners at the 32.
Is to the left of Heupel. Heupel back to pass. He looks, still looking. He'll run out of the pocket. Looks upfield, still looking. Now throws a long pass down for Fagan. It's caught at the 28 in Tech territory, down across the 20. Heupel is amazing. It was a great catch, a pass on the run, and it was perfectly thrown. Curtis Fagan from Houston, Texas beat Paul McClendon, and the ball goes all the way down to the gain, rather, 51 yards to the 17-yard line. How about that? Merv, that Heupel's incredible.
Yeah, we needed that. I think that may jumpstart the offense now, just to get a little success and get ourselves down here at four down territory. It looks like everything they've worked on and want to run has got a chance to be there, Bob.
Wow, that was a heck of a play because he was running to his left, and of course he is left-handed, and lobbed that pass perfectly to Fagan. Two wide receivers left, two to the right, shotgun. No, he's under center now. Josh Norman in motion, gets the handoff, going to a right, on the end around, 15, he's to the 10, and he fumbles the ball on the far sideline.
They recovered.
And I believe Texas Tech has it. They do. Josh Norman was hit, fumbled, and recovered by Antoine Alexander. He caught it in midair, it appeared. Wow, another mistake by the offense. And Josh Norman is, seems to be a little bit of pain as he comes off the field. Let's go down to Mark Matthew for a comment on that, Mark.
Well, he's sort of hanging his right arm right now, and that's usually the indication of a shoulder injury or shoulder separation. Trainers running out to meet him. They'll bring him over to the sideline right now, but Josh Norman,
no,
obviously.
It's not Josh Norman, it's Savage. It's Savage.
Savage?
Yes, it's Savage who's injured. Number six, Savage. The ball is at the 12-yard line in Texas Tech territory. Here's the direct snap to Kingsbury. Looks upfield, throws in the flat, caught by Welker at the 13, and tackled by Roy Williams at the 16. Boy, he's slippery, that Welker. He dodged one tackler, but Roy Williams got him. A pickup from the 12 to the 16. A four-yard pickup, second down, six.
Looks like they're going to try to use him on a lot of things like that because of his elusiveness.
They are working on Savage on the near sideline. Right elbow. It's at the 16-yard line, second down play for Texas Tech at their own 16. Shotgun formation, three wide receivers left. Shad Williams is to his right, man in motion toward the formation is Scoville. Back to pass is Kingsbury. Throws to the far side, has a man. Caught by Norris, and he's out of bounds after a nice pickup on a first down to the 30. Derek Norris makes his first catch of the day, and Michael Thompson tackles him. A 14-yard pickup from the 16 to the 30, and Texas Tech has their seventh first down, trailing Oklahoma 7-0. That's his 50th reception of the year for Norris, who caught four passes and one touchdown against the Sooners a year ago. The ball at the Texas Tech 30-yard line, first down, 10 yards to go. Kingsbury in the shotgun, three wide receivers left and one to the right. Kingsbury drops back a couple more steps, throws up the middle, caught it. Boom, hit immediately for a very short gain of 2 yards. Torrance Marshall greeted Ricky Williams with a bang after Ricky Williams made the short catch right over the middle. Pick up from the 30 to the 32, it appeared. Haven't spotted the ball yet. Maybe the 33. Yep, they'll move it to the 33. Got a good spot. So it's a second down play and seven for Texas Tech from their own 33. No huddle again. They've been going with that most of the game. Man in motion from left to right is Welker. Snap back to Kingsbury. Throws in the flat. Caught by Welker. Gets a block. Gets up to the 35, and holding on is Michael Thompson, but he's short of the first down as he gets from the 33 to the 38 or 9. Welker has about four catches already in this game. That was his fifth there, Terry McLemore tells us. Gain of six on the play from the 33 to the 39. Third down play and a yard to go. Coach Mike Leach said that every time he saw film on Welker, he makes big plays, even though he's not a very big youngster. 5'9", 185, went to Heritage Hall in Oklahoma City. Here we go from the 39, second down play, or third down, rather, and a yard to go. Under center is Kingsbury. Gets the exchange, pitches it to Ricky Williams, sweeping left, hit behind the line, and tackle maybe for a yard loss. Torrance Marshall and Ante Jones.
Great job of reacting to the sweep right there, Bob.
So here we go, fourth down again. Do you think they'll go for it this time?
I don't believe they will.
It's back. They lost a yard back to the 38. We have 12-10 to go before halftime.
But indications are that they are.
This would be what they're... They probably want a measurement just to think it over, but the officials say, well, you don't need a measurement. Okay. Looks like they're going for it, Mark.
Either that
the fourth time, I think.
He'll try to draw them off sides. I don't know. I think he'll probably go for it, knowing Leach.
Under center is Kingsbury. Needs to get to the 40. Ball at the 38. Long signal count. And yeah, now they call time. He was trying to draw them off sides, and we'll take the break. 11:50 to go before halftime. 7-0 Sooners. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. He has a report on Savage. Mark is off the mic for just a moment. He's probably checking out that injury. Oh, Savage is still on the... He's up there standing there. So apparently they did work on him, though, Merv, didn't they?
Yeah, they did. It could be anything from a cut to a bruise. Maybe hopefully it's not serious. I would expect if it were serious, he would not be up there.
All right, we're still waiting for the official to declare time back in. And we have a 7-0 score, 11:50 to go before halftime.
Here comes the punt team.
The punt team coming on the field, and back goes J.T. Thatcher to receive.
Now, see, he's got OU's punt specialists not in the game here as far as our front people. So that's, I guess, what he was trying to accomplish.
Clint Greathouse back to kick the ball. Clinton Greathouse averaging over 44 yards per kick. Snap on the money, fumbled it for the moment. Kicks away from Thatcher. Near sideline, and it's taken by Thatcher. Fumbles the ball, and Texas Tech jumps on it. It appears at the Oklahoma 22. Thatcher had the ball, hit him in the shoulder pads, and recovered by Marquise Turner. Wow. 41-yard punt, a fumble, and Texas Tech gets the turnover at the Oklahoma 22. Boy, how many times can the Oklahoma defense buckle up and stop Texas Tech? Incredible.
It's been shoot yourself in the foot as fast as you can aim right there so far for the Sooners.
A penalty on Oklahoma declined, apparently on the punting play, so they might have gotten the first down, but it would have been way back where it was, where the punt was launched. That line of scrimmage was a 38. Recovered by Turner at the 22-yard line in Oklahoma territory. So from the Oklahoma 22, Kingsbury, three wide receivers left. He's back to pass. Good protection. Now he throws in the flat, way overthrown. Intended for Welker out there. Oh, there was two Texas Tech receivers out there, pretty well covered. Second down and 10 from the Oklahoma 22-yard line.
Pretty good late pressure from his left side, which I'm sure was a little bit of a distraction for him, too. The defense has been rolling the ends and tackles every couple of plays, trying to keep fresh rushers out there.
Holloman is in the lineup again. Barry Holloman from Oklahoma City, Putnam City North, who made that big deflection that Thatcher returned for the only touchdown of this game. 11:36 to go before halftime. In motion now goes Ricky Williams out away from the formation. Four wide receivers left. Raising a quick pass. Williams caught it and juggled it and still held on, though, but he's tackled, I think, behind the line. Roy Williams lost or tackled him for a four-yard loss back at the 26.
They get four players out there. Those three front guys can block for him to run the ball effectively, as Welker can, or throw the ball downfield, as they did a while ago on that halfback pass.
Loses back to the 26. Need to go to the 12 for the first down.
Instead of the ninja, that sort of looks like Coach Leach's special formation this game.
14 yards to go on a third down play at the Oklahoma 26-yard line. Big play here. Under center is Kingsbury. Tight end, both ends. Fakes a handoff. Back to pass. Flat pass. Caught at the 32. Sean Williams has it, but he's tackled about the line of scrimmage by Michael Thompson. Well, they faked the run that time. Then back to pass. Threw in the flat. It was caught. But Sean Williams was brought down at about the line of scrimmage, which was the 26, maybe the 25 is where they'll mark it. And it'll bring in the field goal unit. And that will feature a guy that seems like he's been at Texas Tech for 10 years, Chris Burkholz, who's from Temple, Texas, had hit 84 PATs in a row until he missed a week ago. He's 3 of 7 from this distance. It'll be a 42-yard field goal attempt. A little angle to the right. Holding will be Eric Rosales. Ball is down. Kick is in the air. It's certainly long enough, and let's see if it's good. It is. It goes through the upright. So a 42-yard field goal by Burkholz, and Texas Tech is on the board. It is 7-3 with 10-11 to go in the second period. Sooners lead it. Timeout. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network.
Kicking off for Texas Tech is Clinton Greathouse.
Here in a second.
Clinton Greathouse will be kicking off this time. He'll be kicking off from left to right with the north breeze. Here's the kickoff. End over end will not go into the end zone. JT Thatcher at the 5, to the 10, up the middle of the 15, to the 20, to the 25, to his right, to the 29-yard line. Good return. 24-yard return by JT Thatcher. And he has the only touchdown of the game on that interception return. First down, 10 yards to go for Oklahoma as the offense needs to get something going. Today's official souvenir programs feature a colorful insert saluting the Sooner seniors. Compliments of today's game sponsor, Carl's Jr. Carl's Jr. with 67 locations around Oklahoma. All right, Josh Heupel will be in the shotgun. We have three wide receivers to the right, including tight end Trent Smith, and one wide receiver left. From the Oklahoma 29, Sooners lead 7-3. Heupel backs up a couple of steps. Shot, shovel pass to Quentin Griffin. Up to the 30. Nice run up to the 34-yard line. Dragged down from behind by Aaron Hunt, who is a redshirt sophomore. Has 8 sacks, and he blocked a kick against Oklahoma State a week ago. He was running in heavy traffic all the way on that shovel pass, but the gain went from the 24, from the 29, rather, to the 34. 5 yards picked up. Second down and 5 yards to go from the 20, from the 34-yard line. Need to go to the 39. Now, Ronaldo Works is in the lineup for the first time at running back. Back to passes, Heupel throws, caught by Wilfolk for the first down. He's across the 40 and almost broke away from the tackler. He gets brought down at the 43 by Kevin Curtis. About an 8-yard pickup there and a nice bullet pass to Andre Wolfolk. First down, Oklahoma. And that's first down number 3 in the game for Oklahoma with 9:17 to go before halftime. The game going there from the 34 to the 43 in Sooner territory. Up the line of scrimmage with Josh Heupel in the shotgun. Two wide receivers to both sides. We have 9:05 to go, second period. Heupel back to pass, fires a shot. Good. It's incomplete, almost intercepted. Intended for Savage, banged off his hands.
I'm not sure that was intended for him. He threw that awfully hard.
He did throw it hard.
It's out of character for him. They had a deep corner route by Smith over behind it. I don't know that was intended for Savage.
Savage jumped so high to try to get it. He's made some great catches jumping high, but that time may have jumped and gotten in the way of it. Trent Smith and Mackey wide right. It's a second down 10 from the 43 in Sooner territory. Wolfolk is wide left. Heupel from the shotgun. Quick pass. Caught at the 41-yard line. Mackey, 45. Still going at the 50. Broke one tackle and gets to the 49-yard line in Tech territory where he's gang tackled there. Devin Lemons was the leading tackler from Bryan, Texas. 26-3, 222 defensive end. Got away from Paul McClendon, the safety, after he made the catch in the far flat. The gain goes from the 43 in Sooner territory to the 49 in Tech territory. Third and 2.
Tech's got a lot of speed defensively. I think that characterizes their defense, and they are able to swarm and gather forces on a play like that rather quickly.
Well, you told us in the pregame their defense was very strong, and it is quick. Here we go, third down play for the Sooners. 1 of 3 on third down conversions. Quentin Griffin back in at running back. They're showing blitz here. Heupel from the shotgun. Backs up, throws a pass, caught at the 40. Great pass, Savage to the 35, to the 34, 33-yard line. Nice play, Derek Briggs on the tackle, cornerback on the right side. 14 yards picked up. Man, that's a good pass by Heupel.
It is. Every time they've thrown the hook or the stop route, it looks awfully good. They're playing a lot of zone defense, and they're sticking the ball in there pretty good, Josh is.
Ronaldo works back in the game. He was in earlier. He's there at the 33-yard line in Tech territory. First blitz, pitch back goes to Work, sweeping left, 30, 25, 20, down the sideline and out of bounds at the 17-yard line. Ronaldo Works took the pitch on a sweep left, and Savage appears to be shaken up a bit. He's back at the 29-yard line. He was injured earlier. Great block on that play by Andre Wolfolk. Knocked down Derek Briggs and sprung Ronaldo Works for the game from the 33 down to the 16-yard line is where they're officially marking it. Fifth first down, third in this drive, 17 yards picked up on that sweep by Ronaldo Works on the sweep to the left, and they're still tending to Savage.
Bell rung out there, or got something in his eye, possibly a finger or thumb, but typically, I think when Works comes in the game, many times they do run a quick sweep, Bob. It seems like it's a play. They feel like maybe he runs a little bit better than Quentin. He's had a lot of success with the play early in the year when he had those big numbers rushing.
Let's go down to Mark Matthew. Mark, tell us about it.
Hey, Bob.
Savage apparently got poked in the eye out here. That seems to be his problem right now. Just a little poke in the eye. And earlier, that was a versus problem with his elbow. Nothing to be concerned with.
Off the 16-yard line, first and 10. Sooners in the shotgun at the Griffin and Luttrell to both sides, one side and the other. Of Heupel now goes under centers. He's changing the play. Gets the exchange. Hands the ball off to the trail. He's across the 15. He's to the 10. Still going, and then he's finally hit at the 9 and backed up. Boy, the trail. He wanted that, didn't he, Merv?
He sure did.
He wanted that.
He liked it. Getting that 42 in the end zone just dead.
Right. That was a game then from the 16, almost an 8-yard gain. I think they'll mark it down at the 9-yard line. I think that's where they're going to mark it. So it has 3 yards to go.
That'll catch the defense just a little off balance because typically he leads Griffin, and this time they did it the other way.
Griffin led him and blocked well that time. Lawrence Flugens was knocked out of the way. Here we go. Ball is at the 8.5, actually, officially the 8, they're calling it. Heupel gives the ball to Griffin over the right side, nothing there. But I think Texas Tech looked like they were waiting for it that time. Chris Kaczorek, the defensive left tackle on the stop. Griffin got absolutely nothing. He lost a half yard.
Tech crossed the Sooners F. They went with everybody split out wide, one back in backfield, thinking that they were going to defend again like they had been. And that time they came with a lot of pressure, and there's not enough people to block that play into that defense.
From the 9-yard line, need to go to the 6. It's a 3rd down and 3 for the 1st down, 9 for the touchdown. Mackey in motion from left to right. Shotgun. Heupel waiting for the staff from center from Bubba Burcham. He gets it. The blitz. The pass. And interference should be called. It is at the 1-yard line. It was intended for Wolfolk. And Derek Briggs was all over him before the ball got there. It'll be pass interference on Texas Tech as the field judge called it. That was Brad Van Vark. And he's talking to Steve Juszczyk now. And that's
really
the
wasn't
signal.
That great a pass. The defender lost the ball and played the man and obviously kept the man from reacting back to the ball.
Pass interference.
Behind him.
Defense. Automatic down.
6th first down, 4th on this drive. The ball is at the 2-yard line. 1st down and goal to go. When they're this close, the pass interference occurs. It's where the interference occurred. And it's at the 2. That's why the ball is there. And it's 1st down, goal to go at the 2-yard line. The split backs behind Heupel from the 2. Heupel calls the signals, turns, gives it to Griffin. Right tackle. He gets to the 1 maybe and then pushed back. Gets a yard from the 2 to the Texas Tech 1. This drive started at the Oklahoma 29-yard line. Hello there. 29-yard line, you'll remember. And the Sooners have gone to a 3rd down twice. The big play was the 14-yard pass to Savage, then a 17-yard sweep by Ronaldo Works. Gave him a yard pickup down to the 1. That's where the nose of that football is. And it's 6:03 to go before halftime. 7-3 the score. Oklahoma leads Texas Tech. They scored their touchdown on defense as Thatcher got the interception and ran it back for a touchdown. Matt Anderson wide right, 2 wide receivers left. Shotgun formation from the 1-yard line. Low snap
motion,
and we have flag.
Motion.
Maybe motion on the Sooners, Merv. Wow.
It looked like motion down there somewhere on the right side.
That's pretty tough, these penalties on key
well,
situations.
They just make it so cut and pick it hard. I mean, it's a hard game anyway offensively, and then when you add that to the mix, it gets really tough.
You sound like a coach, Coach.
Really do. You know, it just all those things that you work on all week, and you see them out there,
illegal
they look
snap.
Like pretty good.
On the offense, 5-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
They look like they're going to work for you and everything, and then you just don't give yourself a chance.
Fourth penalty, 37 yards against the Sooners, and a lot of have come at critical times.
This really probably lets Heupel know what he needs to do here more than 2 yards.
From the six, Heupel under center, gives the ball off, fakes it, rolls left, pass, caught at the two, touchdown up Auburn. Trent Smith makes the catch. That's a great fake into the line over the right side. He rolled left and hit Trent Smith for the touchdown. Trent Smith, his second touchdown of the year. And Heupel, gosh, how many touchdowns has he thrown? His 17th touchdown of the year that he has thrown. So the Sooners get that 71-yard drive and finally score, overcoming that penalty there. And that's gratifying indeed.
I'm not sure with Josh. At the 6 or 7 is not better than at the 2 or 3, really.
Well, that was a great fake. Here is Fletcher holding. Here's Duncan's extra point. 54th in a row. And the Sooners are on top 14-3 with 5:38 to go before halftime. We'll take a break. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. So the Red Raiders will be back to receive there at the north end. And kicking will be Tim Duncan into the wind. 14-3, Sooners on top. Online banking at MidFirst is now more convenient than ever. You can view account information, transfer funds, or find out which checks have cleared with the simple click of a mouse. Log on to www.midfirst.com and bank anytime, anywhere. We're waiting for the official to set the ball ready for play. See the award-winning Jeep Grand Cherokee at your Jeep dealer. It's a sure MVP. Shawn Williams is the deepest man. Up man. He's to the near side, along with Carlos Francis. Here's the kickoff. Well, nice kick against the breeze. Shawn Williams right at the goal line, to the 5, to the 10. Bang! Hit into a crowd at the 17. Seth Luttrell, about an 18-yard return, put it at the 18-yard line where it's 1st and 10, Texas Tech. Are you craving something really different? Well, then drive into Sonic for their Coney and Tots special. An extra long chili cheese Coney with large tater tots for just $2.79. This month only, it's a great deal. Sonic, America's drive-in. Texas Tech comes onto the field. Sooner crowd admonished to cause some noise. The crowd has not been that loud today. The loudest we ever heard, I think, was the Nebraska game. Ball at the 18 in Tech territory. 1st and 10, Kingsbury, the quarterback. 3 wide receivers left and a man in motion to the left. That's Shawn Williams. Sooners adjusting. Here's Kingsbury faking a pass to the right, running left, quarterback draw over the right side to the 20, to the 25, to the 30, into the Sooner bench, way up at the 33-yard line. 14-yard pickup or 15-yard pickup. We'll see if they mark it.
See, that's a little counter to that motion that brings out 4 receivers to one side, that they've thrown a halfback pass off of it and then tried to get a ball out to a man in front of, with 3 blockers in front of him, and this time it's a little different play back to the other side.
15-yard gain from the 18 to the 33, and Texas Tech are 8 first down at their own 33-yard line. Shotgun formation. Here's the snap. Kingsbury backs up a couple of steps. Good protection. Throws a short pass. Caught at the 36. Up to the 40 and pulled out of bounds up at about the 44-yard line. And that was Derek Doris from Azale, Texas. Doris' second catch of the day. 11 yards picked up. So Tech moved in 2 plays from their own 18 up to the 45-yard line or in that area. Rocky Kalmus made the tackle, and it was an impressive tackle indeed. But the ball is at the Tech 45. First down and 10 yards to go. 44, they're calling it officially. First down just upfield from the Tech 44. Cretion is in the game for the first time on defense for Oklahoma. Kingsbury from the shotgun backs up. He looks. He has plenty of time. He throws. It's caught and then tackled immediately is Francis. Tackled by Derek Strait. Carlos Francis, who is from Fort Worth, Texas, kick return man and also wide receiver, in for one of the few times at wide receiver today. Picked up 9 yards from the 44 to close to the yard needed for the first down, the 46 and a half in Oklahoma territory. They're moving the ball with impressive quickness here in this drive. Again, the no huddle, and back to passes Kingsbury. Good protection. Short pass caught by Shawn Williams. Easily got the first down across the 40 all the way down to the Oklahoma 36. Torrance Marshall on the stop. Boy, they're really moving the ball now, Murph.
Looks like they know what they want to do right now. They're throwing the ball downfield a little bit more on the second and third plays of this drive, and then that one they dropped it off and let Williams pick up the first down.
Ball is at the 36-yard line, Oklahoma Territory. That was a gain from about 10 yards, more than 10.
Defense needs a big play of some kind here.
4:29 to go before halftime. Sooners lead 14-3. Kingsbury waits the snap from center. Still waiting. Nye gets it. Good protection. Now he's being rushed. He throws a short pass. It's incomplete. Great defensive play by Brandon Everidge, who hit the intended receiver just as the ball got there. Intended for Carlos Francis. Ball popped up in the air, but unfortunately for OU, there weren't any Sooners in the area, or they could have caught that and gone all the way. Carlos Francis really got decked by Brandon Everidge, who, as we all know, can really hit somebody.
He's a little missile.
Second down 10 from the Oklahoma 36. Kingsbury in the shotgun. Three wide receivers left, one to the right. Waiting the snap from the center, Toby Cecil. And it's a bad snap. And
there's
Kingsbury
fumbles
the ball. And the Sooners try to get it back at the Texas Tech 48, but Kingsbury just at the last second pulled that ball into his chest. So a loss from the 36 in Oklahoma territory. Yes, that's a 16-yard loss, Merv.
That's a big play the defense needed. I think that... you know, if they just continue to keep their rushers fresh and those guys get their hands up, Kingsbury is not a particularly tall quarterback. They can have some presence out there.
From the 48-yard line in Oklahoma territory, one of seven on third down conversions, have 26 yards to go on this third down play. Kingsbury back to pass, pump fakes, little screen pass caught at the Tech 48. Sean Williams to the 45, to the 40, and out of bounds, short of the first down, but he picked up good yardage. Picked up 11 yards. J.T. Thatcher shoved him out at the Oklahoma 41. But he's far short of the first down. Will need 15 yards on a fourth down play. And let's see if they go for this one.
Well, they certainly haven't rushed their punt team out here.
They sure haven't.
Here they come.
Fourth and 15 coming up.
I think they're trying to keep the Sooners from getting their punt return team in, although right here that's a little bit moot because chances are this will either go in the end zone or be fair caught.
All right, Great House is in punt formation for Texas Tech. He's punted at 41 yards and 38 yards. Thatcher is single safety, 10 men on the line of scrimmage for Oklahoma. No rush, they're going to do the return here. Pooch kick, Thatcher signals fair catch, takes it at the 9 or 10. 3:30 to go before halftime, about a 31-yard punt for Great House. And the Sooners will have first and 10 at the 9-yard line. Bar S Jumbo and 1-pound hot dogs are the number one selling hot dog in the USA. So if you're hungry, get Bar S all beef hot dogs in Memorial Stadium or your local grocer. Bar S and Oklahoma Beef, it's what's for dinner. Well, Merv, the Sooner offense needs to move the ball here with 3:30 to go before halftime, leading 14-3. Last time they had it was an impressive drive of 71 yards and 10 plays.
Well, they're in the right offense to do it, Bob. Obviously, they don't want to do anything foolish with the football.
From the 9-yard line, under center is Heupel. In motion, Josh Norman from slot left to the right. Handoff goes to Griffin over the right tackle. Gets to the 10, maybe the 11-yard line. Devin Lemons on the tackle, co-captain defensive right end. As Devin Lemons has 78 tackles coming into this game. This is his second or third one today. But it was a gain of two. And run some time off the clock, 3:14, the clock still running. Ball at the 11-yard line in Sooner territory. 8 yards to go. They break the huddle. Trent Smith goes wide right. Three wide receivers left. And the shotgun formation from the 11-yard line. Heupel saying something to his team, perhaps changing the play. They're showing blitz. They are blitzing. Heupel retreats. Short pass, incomplete. It was in the sun, and I don't think Griffin could see the ball coming. And, boy, that was dangerous because it sailed over his head, and his head's pretty short, only 5'7", and it was close to being intercepted.
That's a change of pace for Tech. They've been walking up there, indicating they're going to blitz, got everybody up in there, and then they will bail out late on you. I think the Sooners kind of decided they probably weren't going to again, and they did.
So it's a third down 8 from the 11-yard line in Oklahoma territory. I've been impressed with the Tech defense today. Shotgun formation. Three wide receivers left and one to the right. Again, the blitz. Heupel throws a pass. Oh, boy, almost picked off. Intended for Fagan at the 9-yard line. And very, very close was Devin Lemons. He was dropping off, and had he caught that, it would have been an easy touchdown. So the Sooners don't get anywhere. They pick up 2 yards on first down and two incomplete passes. They'll have to punt it away with 2:48 to go before halftime. Oklahoma leading 14-3. They've had one good drive today. The offense has. And the interception return by J.T. Thatcher of 84 yards. Ferguson back to kick. Standing in his end zone. Back deep to receive is Wes Welker. Waiting for Painter to make the snap. He does indeed, and no danger of the kick being blocked, but not a very good kick. Hits at the Oklahoma 40. Texas Sooner bounce down into Tech territory. Rolls dead at the 45. Boy, that was a fortunate bounce indeed. A 44-yard punt, about the average of Jeff Ferguson. And Texas Tech starts at their own 45. Oklahoma Sooner football brought to you by Dodge. In a perfect world, everything would be different. 2:37 to go before halftime. 14-3 the score, Oklahoma leads. And we'll see if the defense can do it again, Murr.
Kingsbury, the ball carrier.
He was Sooner territory.
Marshall gets credit for the tackle. 6 yards picked up. A limited number of official Sooner game trophies.
With six on the play, Morris Rankin, second and four from the 49.
Good job by Thompson on that play, Bob.
So it's third down play from the Oklahoma 49 and 4 yards to go for the first down. 1 of 8 on third down conversions. 2:01 to go before halftime. Sooners making a substitution or two. Bringing on Corey Klein for pass rushing.
Three-man rush, looks like.
Three-man rush, looks like, here on a third down play and four. Cody's also in there. Now it's the shotgun formation from the Oklahoma 49. Kingsbury backs up. He looks, still looking. Being rushed now. Throws a pass, caught at the 49. And nice play as Kalmus forced the play inside. Welker was the ball, was the receiver. And beg your pardon, it was Derek Doris who was the receiver. And he was tackled initially by Rocky Kalmus, and then the play ended just across the 45, but that's enough for the first down. They needed to go from the 49 to the 45, just across it. 11th first down. Ball is at the Oklahoma 45-yard line. First and 10 for Texas Tech as they keep their drive alive. Toby Cecil is a center. Shotgun formation back to Kingsbury. Kingsbury looks. Nobody open. Now he throws a pass. Underthrown and incomplete at the 27-yard line. Are they going to call it a reception?
No. It's incomplete.
It looked like it was incomplete, yeah. But he got open there. He was wide open, as a matter of fact. The 27th, Carlos Francis, ball will be brought back to the 45 in Sooner territory. Second down play and 10 for Texas Tech from the Oklahoma 45-yard line. 1:34 to go before halftime. 14-3, Sooners on top. Final home game of the year. Oklahoma trying to go 10-0. Shotgun formation. Ricky Williams and Chad Williams to both sides of Kingsbury. Kingsbury back to pass. The blitz is on. Sooners try to get to him, but he gets away from the blitz. Now here's a pass just through. Throws it away and it's intercepted. But is it a complete?
I don't
know. Waiting. Yes, yeah. It is. They get credit for the interception. He got a foot down. Let's go to Mark Matthew. Mark, did you see that?
Question about it, Bob. It was happening right in front of us here at the 35-yard line, and as the reception was made, there was 1 foot down before he went out of bounds. Great call by two officials right here on the sideline.
Derek Strait got it and got a foot down, and that's Derek Strait's second interception of the year, and the Sooners have the ball at the 34-yard line.
Good pressure, Bob, by the rush force there that created that opportunity.
And even with the two running backs in there to block for him,
they sure did.
Good pressure on there.
They really did. Roy Williams, when you blitz him, he can be a factor.
Barry Holloman was in on that. All right, from the 34, first and 10 Sooners. Heupel back to pass. Throws up the middle, and that has to be interference, doesn't it? Yes, here comes the flag. The field judge from way behind the play finally threw a flag. Looked like he was all over. Ryan Aycock was all over the back of Savage. It'll be about a penalty, I'll see, from the 34. Depends on. Here's Steve Juszczyk. Yeah, defensive pass interference is the signal.
First down.
Another first down for Oklahoma. That's their seventh first down, unofficially, at the 41-yard line, Sooner territory, leading 14-3, 1:23 to go before halftime. From their own 41. All three timeouts left for Oklahoma. From the shotgun, blitz, pass thrown, caught at the 40 by Griffin. He can't get around one man, though. Alexander, Antoine Alexander, 21-60-199, a perfect tackle in the open field. Tackle Griffin for a gain of only a yard or two. The line of scrimmage was the 41. Sooners are in their no-huddle offense. Clock is running, and they're messing around with the football. The gain of two to the 43. 59 seconds to go before halftime. Josh Heupel in the shotgun, back to pass. He steps up, rolls to his right, looks to pass, still looking. Now he throws across his body. Savage makes the catch. Well, I think it bounced. It's incomplete. Stops the clock. That's the good news. 47 seconds to go before halftime. Ball will be brought back to the Oklahoma 43. Heupel has shown a lot more mobility this year, hasn't he, Murray?
He really has. I think it certainly probably was a difference in the ball game last week, the last part of that fourth quarter. Needs to be careful about throwing the ball back into the middle off of a scramble like that. Those things can turn out bad for you.
Mackey comes out, and Seth Luttrell in with the Sooner lineup on a third down play and eight for Oklahoma from their own 43. Shotgun formation. Savage wide right. Wolfhook left. Back to pass is Josh Heupel. Throws a long pass. Well, it's picked off at the 34 to the 40. 45, that's Antoine Alexander. 40 down in Oklahoma territory and out of bounds and into the bench. Boy, he stepped in front of, that was Mark Washington. Stepped in front of Wolfolk, and that was a deep post route. And it's the Mark Washington. We'll have to see what his interception. That's his second of the year. And he returned it down into field goal territory, at least, with only 38 seconds to go before halftime. The ball is at the Oklahoma 33-yard line. So, wow. What do you think about that, Merv?
I don't like it. A lot of coverage back there, and only really two prime receivers out that time. He kept the two backs in to pick up the blitz. This blitz that they've used here recently has affected his psyche just a little bit as to whether to send his receivers out or not.
That's the third turnover here in the first half of, for the Sooners. Kingsbury from the 33. The blitz is on. He's back to pass. He throws a quick one. It's dropped. Derek Strait almost picked off one that time. Pass was intended for Tim Baker, but it's incomplete. Clock stops with 34 seconds to go before the halftime gun. Ball is at the Oklahoma 33. Been rather unusual first half in that the Sooners lead 14-3, and yet Texas Tech has had the ball a lot more time as far as the clock is concerned, about more 18-11 as far as time of possession. From the 33, here's Kingsbury. From the shotgun, back to pass, good protection. Now it collapses. He gets away. 35, 30. And down at the 27. How in the world he got away? Derek Stray makes the tackle. Looked like he was surrounded at about the 40. The line of scrimmage being the 33. He got that direct snap, retreated. Clock is still running. We have 16 seconds to go. Gained about six. They have one timeout left. The ball is at the 26-yard line. He wasted about 8 seconds before he called the timeout. 12 seconds to go before halftime. And we will take the break here. Timeout. Oh, we'll keep it here. Okay. And I want to remind everyone, anyone went in Tulsa to stay at the finest hotel, DoubleTree Hotel at Warren Place. Ask for the Sooner Sports Package, a deluxe room and delicious breakfast for two for only $69, a great Sooner deal. And say, OU versus Texas 2000, the Red River Route is now available on video. See all of the exciting action of the entire game, complete with the audio from the radio broadcast on Sooner Sports Network. OU 63, Texas 14, this was a game for the ages. And this video, priced at just $19.95, is a must for all Sooner fans. Order your OU versus Texas video by calling 888-234-9350. That number again, 888-234-9350. Or log on to Soonersports.com to order your video online. Merv, your comments.
I think that it's obvious the problems that the Sooners had. Gysham, what do we have? Lost two fumbles, two interceptions. Pass interference that brought back a first down, blocked field goal. We just, it's just been a disastrous first half from the standpoint. They're fortunate to be ahead, Bob.
That's right. That's what I was saying a moment ago about sort of an unusual first half.
The defense has really played their hearts out. They really have. They kept this ball game even.
Texas Tech now is out of timeouts. That was their last one. They have the ball at the Oklahoma 26. 12 seconds to go before halftime. Trailing 14-3. I would imagine the strategy here, Merv, you got to throw it into the end zone, don't you?
Got to throw it somewhere and stop the clock, either out on the sideline or into the end zone.
Six defensive backs in for Oklahoma. from the 26-yard line. Sooner showing blitz. Kingsbury from the shotgun, back to pass. He looks, he fires a pass, and it's not even close. Intended for Tim Becker, way over his head. 6 seconds to go, and it's fourth down. Guess what, they'll go for it, or will they try another try field goal? They have a field goal from Burkholz, remember, 42 yards. About the same distance, looks like. He's now 4 of 8 from this distance on the year. It's in between the 26 and 27, the line of scrimmage is, and they'll mark the ball down. Let's just say a 43-yard field goal attempt. He'll angle to the right. Rosales is holding. 6 seconds to go before halftime. The snap. The ball is down. The kick is in the air. It's off to the right. No good. Missed it. Off to the right, so the field goal is no good, and that's the end of the first half.
14, Texas Tech 3.
It's 14-3 as the Sooners are back to receive the kickoff in the third period. Oklahoma's beef producers know that if you're a mom, you're a hero every day. Beef's key nutrients, a balanced diet, and healthy lifestyle can give you a lot to go on. Beef, it's what's for dinner. Back to kick the ball will be Greathouse for the Texas Tech Red Raiders from Lubbock, Texas. And back to receive for Oklahoma, J.T. Thatcher and Antoine Savage. And here we go, third period. Sooners lead 14-3. Kicking with the wind. Savage takes it at the 2. Far side to the 5, to the 10, toward the middle, the 15. Tries to go back to his right at the 18. Gets to maybe to the 19. So return of about 16, 17 yards of that kickoff. And they may give him a good spot even close to the 20 there. So the Sooners start from their own 20. And just to recap possessions and what happened in the first half, Sooners had the ball 6 times and scored once. Texas Tech had the ball 7 times, gave up a touchdown, and got a field goal.
Sooner defense has certainly given an outstanding account of themselves. The offense just needs to go out there and help them some here this quarter. Bob.
All right. It's Matt Anderson at far to the right side. 2 wide receivers left. Sooners in the shotgun from their own 20. First play of the third period. Fake to handoff to Griffin over the right side. Gets very little. Heupel handed to him. Then he ran to the left. And nobody followed Heupel, so they weren't. It wasn't a fake, and they gave it to Griffin after all. But Heupel may remember that and fake it the next time. Zeno McCoy on the stop at the end, and no gain on the play. Second down and 10 from the 20.
Didn't get many people blocked on that play, Bob. That defense was not stacked up at all in that area.
2 wide receivers right, 2 wide receivers left. Heupel in the shotgun from the Oklahoma 20. Josh Norman in motion from left to right. Josh Heupel gets the deep snap, throws the short pass, caught at the 18, the Griffin to the 20, and out of bounds. After he was made the reception, made a couple of yards, gets to the 25, so a 5-yard pickup. He's the leading receiver for Oklahoma today. As we mentioned, Quentin Griffin caught that one on a swing pass out of the backfield to the right, short side of the field. Now Seth Luttrell checks in, replacing Josh Norman, and the Sooners face third down play, and they need to go to the 30 from the 25. They're 2 of 6 on third down conversions. We have about a minute gone here in the third period. Sooners lead at 14-3. Have the ball at their own 25 in the first possession here of the third period. 3rd and 5. Heupel from the shotgun. Gets the snap. Backs up 2 or 3 steps. He looks. Still looking. Nobody open. Now he looks upfield. Now he runs the ball. And let's see. He's right at the flag at the 30. It depends on the spot. I think he got a good spot right over there on the far side. Right in front of the Tech bench. Well, Murph, he has done that so much more effectively this year. Well, he didn't do it at all last year. This is the first time today he's really run, and it is first down. Boy, that's a clutch pickup, really.
He's got a little more explosive quickness, I think, and then his presence about how far he needs to go, when it's time to not wait any longer and go, and that sort of thing is so good. Last week we saw him hang around out there and then throw when possibly it looked like he might run. So he really is able to think his way through those situations.
That's the 8th first down for Oklahoma, the first this half. They're up the line of scrimmage from the 30. 3 wide receivers left. Flat pat inside screen. Savage catches at the 28 to the 30, 35. Had a little wall of blockers there and gets to the 38-yard line. And Josh Norman and Duncan, both good blocking on the play. And the gain goes from the 30 to the 38, 8 yards.
Seen that play so much, just like the Sooners have on the one Tech runs it. that they react, you almost have to do something a little different. It's unusual to see him break back outside off that, Bob.
Now Ronaldo works is in a tailback. He's behind Heupel, 2 yards to go. Sweep pitch left to Works. Gets to the 40 and gets the first down easily and gets up to the 45-yard line. Needed only a couple and got from the 38 to the 45. Ronaldo works with the pitch sweep to the left side.
They like
tackled by defensive end Aaron Hunt. Excuse me, Murr.
No, no. They like that toss sweep with him on quick count. And when he comes in, I think almost you can kind of look for this. And it certainly has set up well both times they've run it today. They've had the Tech defense outflanked.
Ronaldo works comes out. Quentin Griffin back in. The ball off the 45 Sooner territory. Matt Anderson from Moore, Oklahoma, the senior tight end, playing his final home game wide to the right side. A slot and a wide receivers, two of them to the left, so actually three wide receivers left. Heupel back to pass. He looks. He throws. Caught by Griffin behind the line. Tries to make somebody miss him. Does. Gets a 47 on the 49-yard line. Nice getting away from a tackler there. Looked like he had him dead to rights, but Heupel was able to get away. I mean, Griffin able to get away from John Norman, Josh's brother who plays for Texas Tech. The game then goes from the 45 in Sooner territory to the Oklahoma 49. The fifth reception for Quentin Griffin, second here in this particular drive. And now Works is back into the lineup, and the ball is at the Oklahoma 49, second down play and six. Being injured on the play was Chris Koshorek, and he is going to leave the game. The coaches want him out of there because he's not responding, and he's walking off under his own power, but he's a little bit shaky. Replaced by Josh Page in the lineup. Josh is from Waxahachie, Texas, 1962-277, sophomore. Had a knee injury earlier this season. Ball at the 49 and to the left of Heupel from the shotgun. Heupel back to pass. He looks, fires a bullet pass, caught at the 46 by Trent Smith. Fumbles the ball.
Wolfolk.
And Wolfolk recovers it. Wow, Trent Smith made his second reception of the day and had it stripped from him, but then it was recovered by Wolfolk. And the gain goes from the Oklahoma 49 down to the 43 in Tech territory. And it's the third first down this drive, the 10th in the game. And the ball is at the 43 after the 8-yard pickup. Paul McClendon stripped that ball after Trent Smith made the catch.
That was an indication there that Heupel can throw it hard when he needs to.
I tell you, sing that in there, didn't he?
He sure did.
From the 43, Tech territory, Heupel under center this time. Ronaldo works behind him. Man in motion, handoff goes to quick handoff to Savage, going around the left side, gets only a yard to the 40, maybe 2 yards to the 41. John Norman tripped him up. That was Savage coming from wide right, sweeping around the left side, getting the handoff. They'll put it at the 41, a 2-yard pickup. Second down, 8 for Oklahoma Tech, 41. Sooners lead 14-3, 12:09 now, the clock running to go in the third period. The top-ranked Oklahoma Sooners with the longest winning streak in the country in NCAA Division I. Savage and Trent Smith wide to the right side. Josh Norman and I believe that's Wolfolk to the left. That's the short side of the field to the left. But all 11 men are up on the line of scrimmage. Now they back away. Heupel gets the snap. Corner blitz. Quick pass. He just got rid of it. And he was decked after he threw it, too. John Norman really hit him. And it's third down play and 8 from the 41-yard line in Tech territory.
Their blitzes the last half quarter of the first half and this have been fairly effective when they come in there, and then they show you the blitz early, which obviously you can't be sure they're not coming. I think really if you go in reverse, if they look like they're coming, they're probably not.
Griffin comes in and Seth Luttrell are to either side of Heupel, 3 of 6 on third down conversions from the Tech 48. He tried to jump high and catch it, but he had to get it over a defensive player's head, and he's a little bit too tall for Savage. It's fourth down from the Tech 41. And the Sooners will be forced to punt the ball as Jeff Ferguson checks in. So that was a good drive. 3 first downs from the 20 to the Tech 41, from the Oklahoma 20 to the Tech 41. Got about 40 yards on the drive, but have to punt it away here.
Right tackle got beat on pass protection, and Josh had to throw it a little quicker under more pressure than he needed to.
Ferguson back to kick the ball. Back to receive is Wes Welker, standing at the 17, because they assume that Ferguson will pooch it. It's real high. Let's see what happens. It hits it. Oh, it skips into the end zone. Wait a minute. No, it's at the 2-yard line. It's a 1 is where he marked it. The official was standing there, and he walked up and waving his hands. It looked like for the moment he was signaling a touchback, but it's out of bounds at the one. Timeout. Great pooch kick by Ferguson. 11:32 to go third period. 14-3 Sooners. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. From the one, Texas Tech from their own one. Single tailback, Ashad Williams, man in motion. Give it to Ashad Williams, he's hit. It's very close to the goal line. Roy Williams got him, but they're going to give him forward progress. I think he's lost about a half yard there. Boy, that was close, Murray.
It really was. They stood him up as he went to the goal line. He stood straight up and went nowhere. Excellent play by the defense.
Right there at the line of scrimmage. It's second down and 10 from the one. North end zone crowd really standing and yelling. That's right where they are, where Texas Tech is at their own one, actually behind their own one. Kingsbury under center. Sooners stacking there pretty close. Kingsbury fakes the handoff. Back to pass. He throws a pass upfield. It's incomplete. Little underthrown at the 10-yard line as Kingsbury had to get it away in a hurry, and Tim Baker was the intended receiver. So it's third down and 10 from their own one-yard line. Might have been tipped at the line of scrimmage. 14-3 Sooners lead with 10:51 to go. We're seeing a replay on the Sooner Vision. See if we can see whether it was tipped. Might have been tipped by Torrance Marshall. We're not sure. Got another look at it. All right. 2 of 10 on third down conversions. They're in the shotgun formation. Standing 5 yards deep in his end zone is Kingsbury on a third and 10 from the one. Kingsbury, quick short pass, caught at the 1 yard line. Missed tackle. Ashad Williams is tackled by Derek Strait. He doesn't miss it at the 7 yard line. So they will have to kick the ball away, and the good defense by the Sooners stops them at the Texas Tech 7-yard line. So three and out, Merv. That's the way you like to start second half.
That's an outstanding job of the defense. Obviously, it's a tough area of the field offensively to operate, but the defense did an extremely good job of just hanging in there and making a good tackle on third down.
Clinton Newhouse is averaging 38.9 yards per kick coming in this year from Roswell, New Mexico. Back to kick. J.T. Thatcher standing in Tech territory at the 48 to receive it. A low snap, but he gets it in good shape and puts a toe into it and kicks a nice kick. Thatcher backs up, takes it to the Oklahoma 44, comes to his left, now comes back to the right, dodges two tacklers, but nobody there to block for him, and he's tackled at really about where he caught the ball. About a 48-yard punt and a 4-yard return. And the Sooners have good field position nonetheless, as they have it at the 49-yard line in Oklahoma end of the field. Their second possession here in the third period, as the Sooners were way behind on time of possession in the first half. I realize they don't win and lose games because the Sooners were leading 14-3 at the time, but still, you want your offense to be clicking, and they did not click all that well in the first half.
This is a great opportunity for them to begin to click right here. They've got good field position. We need to go right here, Bob.
From the Oklahoma 49, Heupel in the shotgun. Back up a couple of steps, back to his left. Cuts up field, gets very short yardage, may got a yard. Tackled by Aaron Hunt, who is from Denison, Texas, and 26-3 and 239. Quentin Griffin started to go wide right after the shovel pass was caught, but there was nothing there. Went back to his left, and very little there. He got only a yard to the 50.
Got a lot of people that can recover and pursue with great quickness on this defense. You don't need to mess around with them. You need to go.
Luttrell checks in, replacing Mackey. Wolfhook wide left, two wide receivers wide right. As we have Heupel under center from the 50, second down, 9 yards to go. And now Heupel backs up, and we have Heupel changing the play and backed up into the shotgun. Meanwhile, it was Chris Kaczorek who jumped across the line of scrimmage when Heupel backed up. The discussion, no doubt, will center on whether Heupel drew them offside. Or
well, Bubba snapped the ball while he was in the motion. The only thing, Bubba didn't get the ball on back to the quarterback. I have no idea whether that has any bearing.
Well, Bertram is really upset. Bubba is.
I think maybe they'll just...
They called one illegal snap on the day.
I don't know whether they'll make play the down over again.
We'll have to wait for Steve Juszczyk and his crew to decide what to do. This is the same crew that called a penalty on Oklahoma in the Kansas State-Nebraska game. when they were 500 miles south. Illegal procedure against Oklahoma. But he did not turn the microphone on, or we couldn't hear it anyway.
He did not turn loose of the football. He snapped it but held it himself, and I suppose this is maybe the reason. I don't know. I've never seen that happen before. Yeah, it got away from him after a bit. But
14 yards to go, Merv, on a second down play after the penalty ball at the Oklahoma 45. Damian Mackey, Wolfolk, and Fagan in the lineup, all wide left. Tight end on the right side, Matt Anderson. Here's the shotgun snap back to Heupel, looks to his left. Now fires a pass, caught at the 49 in Tech territory. Matt Anderson butts his way downfield and gets the first down inside the 40. Boy, that was a heck of a run. He caught the ball at the Tech 42. One guy tried to tackle him. He just put the head down like a billy goat and butted him out of the way and got down to the 39s where they mark a 17-yard pass play. Matt Anderson, good play.
Oh, big play. Really needed that after flopping around there on second down, only gaining 1 yard on first down and having all that go on and wind up getting penalized. That's a play the Sooners really needed. Let's hope they can build on it.
Ran over McClendon on that play. He got the brunt of the butt, if you know what I mean. Here's Heupel under center, handing off. And a double reverse. Wolfolk gets in the handoff. Goes to the right. He's the 40. He's the 35. He's at the 30 and out of bounds. First down. Boy, that was a double reverse in heavy traffic, friends. That was like a busy street where you live. As they handed off, just barely got the handoff. Quentin Griffin, Andre Wolfolk. Griffin got the handoff out of the backfield coming left. Handed off to Wolfolk. Going back to his right, and he dodged a couple of tacklers and got 11 yards on the pickup from the 39 to the 28. Picks up the 12th first down for Oklahoma. The ball at the Texas Tech 28. Oklahoma leading 14-3. And the Sooners quickly up the line of scrimmage. Ronaldo works in the lineup now from the 28 in Tech territory. Heupel backs up. Good protection. Throws a pass downfield. Caught at the 7. Works to the 10. He dropped it. Boy, he had to turn around to make the catch. And he was thinking about running with it, but he dropped it. Boy, that was a perfect pass seen to me.
It really was. Don't be too easy on him, Bob. That ball hit him right in the chest. That would have been a touchdown. Big play. Big play.
Jarvis Smith checks in the lineup. First time today. Griffin and Josh Norman and Savage. Wholesale substitutions. And a second down and 10 from the Tech 28-yard line. Boy, I tell you, that was one you hate to not get.
Those are the kind that happen when you're just not quite in sync, Bob. It just seems to go on and on and on.
From the 28 in Tech territory, from the shotgun, three wide receivers to the short side of the field. That's to the right. Here's the snap to Heupel. Bit low. Blitz. Ball caught behind the line. Josh Norman, 32, 30, 25, 20, 15 to the 10, down to the 6-yard line. Boy, what good speed. Great speed by Josh Norman, who turned it on. 23-yard pickup from the 28 down to the 6, and Devin Lemons finally brought him down.
That's great execution, Bob. I've got to think Tech knew probably what was coming because they put the three receivers over into the boundary. Nobody wide on this side. You've got to think the wide receiver screen, and they blocked it perfectly. Had a big hole.
22 yards picked up officially from the 28 to the 6. Ronaldo works in the lineup. Single tailback from the 6. There's the pitch to work, sweeping left, cuts at the 10, he's at the 5, he's in for the touchdown, Oklahoma. I don't see any flags, although Works moved just an eyelash before the ball was snapped.
Yeah, he
snapped.
Did. A back can go in motion.
Right, but I'm saying.
I don't think that's what they forgave him for, Bob. I think maybe they didn't quite see it.
Well, Merv, you called it as usual. You said that when the Sooners got the ball at their own 49 that they needed to make something happen. Matt Anderson with a key third down play, or second down play, and then a 22-yard pass and run to Josh Norman, and then the 6-yard sweep by Ronaldo Works. His 5th touchdown of the year. The Sooners are on top 20-3, and here comes the extra point. North end zone, ball down, kick in the air, and it's perfect. Tim Duncan has not missed this year. We have a timeout. 21-3, Sooners lead it. 7:56 to go, third period. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. All right, Sooners kicking off from right to left, south to north. That's Tim Duncan. He booms it downfield. Well, that's a nice kick. Kicks away, hits in the end zone. Shad Williams watches it bounce, and it's dead, and the ball will be brought out to the 20-yard line. Ball will be brought out to the 20. First down, 10 yards to go for the Texas Tech Red Raiders. And now the Sooners have totally dominated, Merv, this third period. Tech has run 3 plays and punted. That's it in the third period. And we have 7:49 to go in the third period.
I like that. Let's keep it going. That's field position. So they were backed up on their own 1-yard line. And not a whole lot of opportunity to operate without taking a chance.
We have Corey Heineke, Corey Collins, Ryan Fisher, Ramon Richardson, Torrance Marshall, Rocky Kalmus in the lineup, and then 5 defensive backs. Shotgun from the 20. Kingsbury back one step, throws a quick inside screen, caught by Welker, gets a couple of 3 yards. He caught it at the 22, got about to the 24. Roy Williams from Union City, California. Strong safety makes the stop at the 20, put the 24. Officially calling it the 23. Sixth reception for Welker for 69 yards. Second down play, a little less than 7 yards to go in the area of the 23 and a half, Texas Tech territory. Man in motion from left to right is Darnell Jones. Sooners showing blitz. Let's see if they do. Kingsbury back to pass. Short pass. He is overthrown. Intended on the near side for Ricky Williams out of the backfield. Good pressure put on by Ryan Fisher. Third down from the 23 and about 7 yards to go.
We've seen it from Tech too, Bob, but typically when a team shows blitz that early, especially with their safeties, usually they're bluffing it. Usually they'll bring out into his own coverage or at least in a certain area to try to maybe pick up an interception.
2 of 11 on third down conversions, ball at the Tech 23, need to get to the 30 for the first down. In the lineup now is Corey Klein, right on the nose of that center. Three-man rush, back to pass Kingsbury, plenty of time, throws a pass, caught at the 29. I don't think he'll have the first down, but we have another decision by Mike Leach. And one of the Sooners slow getting up. Doris made the catch. Derek Doris, 21-6-2, 200-pounder. And, boy, he's a half yard away from that first down. But it's at the Tech 29. Will you see if Mike Leach, trailing 21-3, wants to go for it here?
Yeah, they're going to go for it. You need to be sure and stop the sneak right here and then play the best you can on anything else.
Ramon Richardson's in there, and Tech will go for it. Well, I don't see much percentage in this, but when you're down like this and the underdog, last game of the season, why not, huh? Under center, Kingsbury trying to draw him offside. Now he calls timeout. So let's take the break. 5:53 to go, third period. 21-3 Oklahoma leads Texas Tech. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. Texas Tech needs about 6 inches for the first down. And you know what? It looks like they got a good spot from when they had the timeout. I think the center moved it up about a half yard. Crowd is cheering, trying to. Fourth down play. What is this? The fifth time? 1 for 3 on fourth down attempts. And they came into the game 40% on fourth down. Here we go. Less than a yard. Throwing 29 yard line. Kingsbury.
He didn't get it.
I'm not sure he got it. Let's see. I believe they're going to give him the spot at the 30-yard line. Boy, he didn't get much, though, Merv Johnson.
He got a very good spot. I mean, they popped him straight up in the air instantaneously.
Headlinesman says first down, so Texas Tech has their 12th first down of the game. First of this half, and they have it at the 30-yard line there into the field. All right, it's shotgun formation now as Tech quickly ready to go. Two wide receivers left, and actually what amounts to three to the right. Now a man in motion from left to right is Welker. Kingsbury gets the snap, a high snap, flat pass, caught behind the line of scrimmage on a screen, tackled immediately at the 33-yard line is Carlos Francis. 5'9", 188, redshirt freshman from Fort Worth Southwest High School. The umpire will spot the ball at the 33, as we called it, a 3-yard pickup. Second down 7 for Texas Tech, trailing Oklahoma 21-3. With 5:13 to go in the third period. All right, ready to go. Again, they don't. We've not mentioned a tight end because they don't use a tight end. Texas Tech has wide receivers, two left and one right. Back to pass Kingsbury. Pretty good protection. Throws caught at the 36. Down immediately. Derek Strait hits the receiver immediately. Francis again makes the catch. Now that's Carlos Francis. Got about three more from the 33 to the 36. So now we have third down play and 4 for Texas Tech from their own 36.
Those type passes sure keep the clock running, don't they, Bob?
They do, and they help the Sooners because they lead by 18 points.
It's a deal where they give up a lot of clock for a 2-yard gain.
Carlos Francis in motion, wide left. Now the three wide receivers left from the 36. Third down play. Back to pass Kingsbury. Good protection. Now he's hit from behind and spun down by Corey Collins. Nobody saw him. He came around from behind, and Kingsbury tried to step up. Second sack of the day and the fifth of the season for Corey Collins. And the loss results in loss from the 36 back to the 33. And it'll be punt time now. for Mike Leach's Texas Tech Red Raiders. They'll call it the 32, so a four-yard loss on the second sack of the day. Well, the defense played great the entire game, but especially here in the third period.
I think it's so critical they make those sure tackles on those short type pass completions.
Clinton Greathouse back to kick the ball. Oh, it's a low snap, bounces to him, but the Sooners didn't have the block on. A beautiful kick. Wow, JT takes it back at the 10-yard line, about a 56-yard kick. Up to the 20, breaks into a hole at the 30, 35, to his right, the 40, 45, 50, to the 45, to his right, to the 40, and the ball is fumbled. It's on the floor of the stadium, and they're piling on, and I think Dante Jones missed it. Let's see who got it. Somebody knocked the ball free as he cut to the right side, and the ball hit the floor of the stadium, and the ball is at the 38, and let's see who recovered it. A 50-yard return after a 56. Wow. Let's see who gets off. Ought got to be. Brandon Everidge comes up with it, and he shows the crowd, look what I got.
He recovered that one twice on that play, didn't he?
I think he did. And we have a flag on the far side we just saw back at the 34-yard line. So let's read that. And they'll be moving it back. 50-yard return. At least the Sooners kept the ball, right, Merv?
Yeah, they sure did. But, gosh, you know, hang on to the football. You get a good return like that, regardless. The penalty, obviously, the way the cover team was scattered out.
Well, we thought the official use check was going to talk to us, but his mic was cutting out.
The way the cover team got scattered out, Bob, it's hard for me to think that it was a very fragrant foul on the Sooners.
Well, they call blocking below the waist, and that's a signal they gave. The ball has moved back to the 24. So rather than having it at the 38 in Texas Tech territory, they end up having it at the 24. 10, 20, 30, some odd, almost 38-yard penalties, what that amounts to. Wow. That's they credit J.T. Thatcher with a 24-yard punt return. Now they're moving it back even farther.
They didn't get him enough. They did
back to the 19. That's actually a 15-yard penalty. That's a 44-yard penalty. Well, that's a little severe, if you ask me. The ball is at the Oklahoma 19. Sooners leading by a score of 21-3, 3:18 to go third period. Man in motion. That's Quentin Griffin back to pass. Heupel throws, caught by Wolfolk at the 17. And from behind, he's tackled, and the flag is down. Aaron Hunt makes the tackle. I don't know what the flag was. It occurred where they play ended at the 17, which was a loss of two, even on the completed pass. Carter, maybe that's a little bit of a makeup there.
Not enough, Bob.
That's right. Sooner football brought to you by Trane and your Trane dealers. Trane offers heating and air conditioning products for every size home and every size budget. It's hard to stop a Trane. And Carl's Jr. is proud to sponsor today's Oklahoma Texas Tech game, as we indicated. Be sure and call the Carl's Jr. Star Line for customer response at 1-866-81-HAPPY. That's 1-866-81-HAPPY.
That was a big face mask penalty, too, Bob.
So that's the third penalty for 29 yards on Tech. The ball has moved up to the 34, and it's the 14th first down for Oklahoma at their own 34-yard line after the penalty is marked off. So the play slowed down by the flags in both ends. Oklahoma first and the blocking below the waist, and then face mask on Texas Tech. And the umpire is talking to one of the Texas Tech Red Raider co-captains. That's Devin Lemons, explaining things. And we have Juszczyk, the referee, going to one bench. Now they're asking timeout. Texas Tech is. So we'll take the break. 3:12 to go third period. 21-3 Oklahoma leads. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. First and 10 after the 15-yard face mask penalty was marked off against Texas Tech. From the 34, shotgun formation. Luttrell and Griffin are to one side and the other of Heupel. Handoff goes to Griffin up the middle. He cuts to the 40. He is to the 45. Almost broke that one. Gets the 49-yard line. Oh, man. Good blocking over the right side. Skinner and Kempany got 15 yards on that carry. Let's pause for station identification. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network.
First down, Sooners.
Obbery, Merv Johnson, and Mark Matthew. And our crew with balls at the 49, Oklahoma, hard line. Nice run by Quentin Griffin, who's had two runs in a row. Pretty impressive. That was 6 yards. First and one to go was 15 yards. That goes from the 49 in Sooner territory down to the Texas Tech 45. 6 yards picked up, as we said. Second down play. Well, the running game figures in. That's what the Sooners have added this year that they didn't have last year, really.
I think it certainly has been a good addition. I think that, Bob, I think there's still times that we struggle a little bit with this, you know, in third and two and third and one and those kind of situations.
So the Sooners, I think, are going to call sideline warning is what the... So the whistle will blow and Steve Juszczyk will start the clock running again. The ball is at the 45 in Tech territory. It's a second down and four. Again, shotgun with Quentin Griffin to his left, and there's a handoff to Griffin over the right side to the 40, to the 35, to the 30, down to the 29-yard line. Griffin, that's three plays in a row that Griffin has carried the ball. Kempenick and Skinner are blocking big holes for him. He gets flat time 15 from the 45 down to the 30. He has a total of 43 yards on nine carries in the game, and on the last three plays, 36 yards, Merv.
He really has. They've run the same play over there to that right side three times in a row. Quentin's out now, and Works is in. Here comes the sweep, Bob, right at us.
Three wide receivers left. There's the pitch sweep. Coming left is Ronaldo Works. They were looking for it, and they tackle him for a loss.
Went to the well too many times.
Went to the well too many times, didn't they? Yeah. Nice tackle by John Norman, the brother of Josh Norman, playing for Texas Tech, as we've mentioned two or three times. So he loses from the 30. Ronaldo Works does back to the 39. It's a 9-yard loss.
Got to give those defenses a little more credit. And, you know, they're not going to let you beat you over the head with the same instrument all day, I don't think. You had to think they would react better that time.
Trent Smith checks in at tight end, and Josh Norman is out, and Seth Luttrell in at running back. Shotgun formation, second and 19 from the Tech 39. Sooners lead 21-3 with a minute 3 to go in the third period. They're showing blitz. Let's see if they do. They back out of there with a corner blitz, and Heupel with a flag down runs with it, and they tackle him by the neck at the 37-yard line. Chris Kishorek makes the stop.
They got a holding back here in Noble, though.
I believe the holding, the flag dropped at the 50. That's closer to Purcell, I think.
Oh, that's a killer.
That's going to move them way back if that's where it happened at the 50.
They might turn that one down.
The game went.
The field position is going to be so horrendous because of it.
They'll take the penalty. The gain was only 2 yards. Would have brought up a third down play and long, but they're going to take the penalty. Instead of having it at about the 38, penalty all the way back to the Oklahoma 41. Seventh penalty, 72 yards. Ball at the Oklahoma 41. It's going to be second and 39. Wow. Two wide receivers left, two wide receivers right. Shotgun formation. Oklahoma leading 21-3, 44 seconds to go third period. Bubba Burcham, the center. Heupel in the shotgun, as we mentioned. Backs up about three steps after he gets it. He's hit as he throws a pass. It's intercepted at the 40. That's McClendon at the 50. And then he's hit hard by Seth Luttrell at the Oklahoma 46-yard line. He was hit as he threw the ball in the second interception of the day on Josh Heupel, picked off by Paul McClendon from Stanford, Texas. He was a former punt returner, and he did a good job returning that interception there. And let's check the stats here. I believe that's his first of the year. It is.
It's really a poor job picking up the blitz over on the right side. That two down linemen came. They had their hand on the ground, and one of them they let completely go. Obviously, you knew he would probably rush. Josh didn't really have much of a chance. The guy got in there and hit him just about the time he topped his arm.
So the ball is at the Oklahoma 47-yard line, and Texas Tech, obviously, with their best field position of the third period. Shotgun. Cliff Kingsbury takes a one-step jump. Shovel pass is caught, and the ball is fumbled. Let's see, it may be incomplete. It was. It was a shovel pass intended for Shawn Williams in heavy traffic, and Barry Holloman, who has played a great game defensively, broke that up. What it amounted to. So even though it's a shovel pass, still an incomplete pass.
I think the Sooners have missed Barry's play, and they've missed his height. He's the one guy we've got with height that can bat a ball. I think you've said he's tipped two or three today.
Right, 6'4 is his height. All right, shotgun with one running backs either side of the quarterback. Sooners have a blitz, and the flag is
motion.
Thrown, and it should be a motion penalty because they stopped the play. That's usually, it's always on the offense when they stop the play. Let's see who, we can't see who the guilty party was. 16 seconds to go, third period. Illegal procedure against Texas Tech. Fourth penalty for 34 yards. The ball was at the Oklahoma 47, so that'll move it back to the 48 in Texas Tech territory. And we'll bring up a second down play and 15. Sooner football brought to you by State Farm Insurance and the State Farm agents throughout Oklahoma. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Ball is at the 48-yard line in Tech territory. Shotgun formation, two wide receivers right, one to the left, second and 15. Back to pass Kingsbury. He throws. It's caught by Doris. Doris is wrestled out at the 42 in Sooner territory by Michael Thompson. Derek Doris, 6'2", 200-pound senior, three-year letterman. Picked up about 10 on the play from the 48 in Tech territory to the Oklahoma 42, and 1 second to go, and there is the end of the third period. That's the end of three quarters. Oklahoma leads at 21-3 after three. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. Two under center is Kingsbury. Two of third down. He fakes the handoff. He rolls right. He throws a pass. It is incomplete at the 32, thrown out in front of the intended receiver, Darrell Jones. Michael Thompson defending on the play. And now it's a fourth down play from the Oklahoma 42 for Texas Tech. For Heupel, he's 18 of 29, one touchdown and two interceptions. For Kingsbury, he's 28 of 44 for 196 yards and two interceptions. Passing yards, 188 for Oklahoma and 208 for Texas Tech. Total yards, 313 for Oklahoma, 221 for Texas Tech. Four turnovers for Oklahoma, the most in any game this year. They're going to go for it on fourth down for the fifth time in the game. From the 42, Kingsbury, quick spot pass, caught, first down by Baker. He's at the 35, 30, and down to the 27-yard line. Quick slant pass to Tim Baker from Borger, Texas, playing for Texas Tech, of course, and the ball is at the 27. So a gain from the 42 to the 27, a 15-yard pickup on the pass play on fourth down.
Great catch, Bob. The ball was a little behind him and on a slant. That's a tough catch to make.
He's their leading receiver, and it's first down number 13 for Texas Tech at the Oklahoma 27-yard line. Under center is Kingsbury. Takes it. Gives the ball off. That's Foy Munlin from Dallas Kimball. He's a true freshman. First carry of the game. First time he's been in the game. Foy Munlin, 6'0", 218, 18 years of age. And he's a good blocker, but he carried the ball that time from the 27 to the 24. Straight handoff. That's one of the few straight handoffs they've had all day. At the center, 24, second down play. 7 yards to go. Shotgun this time. Kingsbury back. Gets the snap, looks down the middle, still looking. He's being chased. Pressure is chasing him out of the pocket. He fires one, caught, and out of bounds immediately. And that's Carlos Francis, first down at the 15-yard line. Kingsbury, got to give him credit. He's a pretty good quarterback, Murray.
He really is. He's very mobile, very mobile. Looked like they had him back there for a loss, and he escaped, got outside, and gathered himself, and made a nice completion. Great job of the receiver, too, sitting down out there where he's a good target, well in bounds.
So it's a 9-yard pass play and a first down at the Oklahoma 15-yard line. Sooners leading 21-3 with 14:09 to go in the fourth period. Shad Williams is to the right of Kingsbury, who's in the shotgun. Kingsbury backs up a couple of steps. He looks. He lobs a pass downfield to the four, and it's caught, but is he out of bounds? They're saying he's inbounds, at a foot inbounds at the four, and that's Derek Doris. I believe that's his fourth catch of the day. And it's at the Sooner four, and it'll be first and goal to go for Texas Tech. They got this ball after the interception of the Josh Heupel pass by McClendon. They got it at the Oklahoma 47, were set back by a penalty, and it was second and 15 from the Tech 48. But they've overcome that and have the ball first and goal at the Oklahoma 4-yard line. So now it's a shotgun formation, three wide receivers left and one to the right. See if the Sooners can hold them out from the four. Waiting for the snap. Kingsbury gets the snap. He looks. He throws. Caught at the five by Francis, and he'll lose a yard. J.T. Thatcher had him immediately. And so it's a loss of a yard on the completed pass there. Good defense by the Sooners.
It really was. They was excellent anticipation. You get that cluster of three guys out there, you can anticipate the wide receiver screen, and then it's just a matter of the defense out executing the offense.
If they had a little more field, obviously you can fake that and take off, but they may be too close to the back of the end zone right here.
So the Tech brings in a tight end, Cole Roberts. He caught a pass earlier in the game on a swing, on a hook and ladder type thing, but
probably some kind of a bootleg.
Let's see. Everything is to the right. Overloaded to the right side. Kingsbury rolls to his right. He looks.
Holding.
He still looks. He's still looking. Now he steps up. Now he throws it away in the end zone. Corey Cowles put the pressure on him. Boy, it seemed like he had all day, but still, it was a good coverage by the Sooners.
It was. They held the Sooners' left defensive end so bad out there.
But not called.
Not called. You miss a lot of those, obviously, but that's what buys you so much time when you tackle a defensive end.
Kingsbury is 32 of 50 for 250 yards. 230 yards, I'm sorry. Now it's a third and goal from the five. 2 of 14 on third down conversions. Wide to the right side is Darrell Jones.
Got to figure that.
Left side is Carlos Francis.
Trying to get the ball to 81 somehow.
Shotgun. Baker's in the slot. He's the leading receiver. Sooners blitzing. Kingsbury is hit just as he throws, and the ball is overthrown, incomplete. In the end zone, on the flag will be pass interference on Michael Thompson. Pass was intended for Darrell Jones. Average hit him as soon as he threw the ball, but it'll be pass interference, and that'll give him first and goal at the one, I believe, since it occurred in the end zone. Well, that's a tough penalty. Sooners have had tough penalties all day. They lead 21-3 with 13:09 to go in the game. And let's see what the where they'll spot the ball at the two rather than the one. So that's what the third pass interference on OU today. One on the offense and two on the defense. And it's now first and goal. That's their 16th first down. The ball at the Oklahoma 2-yard line. Ricky Williams is behind Kingsbury. You figure he's going to get it, and he does. He goes. He hit right there at the line of scrimmage. Corey Cowens knocked him down, and then Torrance Marshall helped out. Well, there was nothing there for him. Great defense. Ricky Williams, 4 carries for minus 3 yards today. I think he lost half a yard at least. They call it a 3 now, second and goal. Let's see, Munlin comes in. Foy Munlin from Dallas, who carried the ball, remember, earlier. And leaving the game is but Tim Baker. They go with two running backs in there as he goes under center. Ricky Williams, and it'll be Kingsbury carrying the ball. He's tackled short of the goal line with the one. Corey Heineke made the last-ditch tackle, grabbing around the shoelace as Kingsbury rolled out to his right, got out of the pocket and got out of the containment, and looked like he could run it in. He thought he could. He got 2 yards to the one. It's third and goal from the one.
It is. The defense is hanging as tough as they can down here against all odds, really.
Stephan comes into the lineup. In for Ante Jones. Roger Stephan in. And now they break their huddle, and they have two wide receivers, Baker and Darrell Jones wide right, one wide left. Now they're switching Darrell Jones to the left side. And Kingsbury wants a timeout. This is their last timeout with 11:42 to go in the fourth period, and it's 21-3 Sooners. So we'll take a break. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. Nothing that time. He'll lose a yard or two. They started at the two. They lost back to the three. They gained down to the one. Now they lose back to the three, and it's fourth down and goal to go. And the field goal unit comes on. Merv, I tell you, that's just a great defensive stand.
It is. It is. After the interference penalty in the goal line, in the end zone, to be able to actually push him back a yard or two is tremendous.
Could be a fake, of course, but I would doubt it. Chris Burkholz from...
You got to think the Sooners are looking for a fake.
20-yard deal here, field goal attempt at the north end zone. He's 4 for 4 from this distance, just like an extra point. Ball is down, kick is in the air, and it's good. He hit a 20-yard field goal, but it's a moral victory for the defense as the crowd really cheers them. Texas Tech had first and 10, or first and goal at the 4, at the 5, at the 2, at the 3, at the 1, and then finally kicked the field goal. So it's 21-6 Oklahoma, 10:55 to go fourth period. That's terrific.
It really is, and to think that Tech got the ball on the Sooner side of the 50-yard line at the 47-yard line and were able to hold them, that's great.
Timeout. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. We're back with you, and Merv, it looks like the Sooners suspecting an onside kick here with 10:55 to go and the score 21-6 Sooners.
Time.
What'd you say, Merv? Go ahead.
I say I'm not sure if I were Tech, I wouldn't kick it away and hope the Sooners would turn it over one more time. Their percentages might be, the way it's going today, more in that favor than they would be of recovering an onside kick.
Greyhouse booms it downfield indeed, so not the onside kick. And it's taken by Thatcher at the 2. He'll return it. Comes to the 10, spins at the 15, and a flag is thrown very late. That was about a 15-yard flag thrown by the referee. So the play ended at the 15. Let's see what the penalty is all about. Steve Juszczyk, the official, talking with both captains there. Let's see. Sooners will not have good field position. Let's see if it's on them. Holding against Oklahoma. Well, the Sooners have been called for more penalties today than they have in any game this year. That's the 9th penalty today. Ball is back at the 8-yard line for 83 yards in penalties.
Seems like every one of them has really been in such a poor time to hurt so badly. Well, not a very good job by JT. He's picking his way right there. He ought to grab that ball and took off and tried to cut down some of that coverage distance.
Heupel will go under center from the Sooner 8-yard line. First down and 10 yards to go. Sooners leading 21-6. Back to throw. Heupel retreats back into his end zone. Now fires a shot and just throws it away. Intended for Quentin Griffin. Second and 10. Defensive end and by Chris Koshorik, left tackle. Well, I will say this. Texas Tech's done a pretty good job covering the Sooner receivers today.
Well, they have. I don't quite know what they were doing right there. I don't know whether he had somebody over here and he wanted to throw to and they covered him and just swallowed him and then he tried to turn it into something or what.
Quentin Griffin is behind him, an offset eye formation now for the Sooners as Heupel's under center. Seth Luttrell is the offset fullback. They're showing blitz. Now they back out of there from the 8-yard line. Handoff goes to Griffin over the right tackle. He gets about a yard maybe back just to the line of scrimmage. Long time left on the clock, 10:32 to go in the fourth period. Sooners leading 21-6. And the ball is still at the 8-yard line, so it's third and 10. No gain on that carry by Quentin Griffin.
Well, that penalty on the return, Bob, puts you in such a bind. You can't do anything real foolish down here or real risky.
Damian Mackey coming in very late. Play clock's at 13. Comes in for Luttrell. Sooners break the huddle. 3 wide receivers go left and 1 to the right. Play clock at 6. Heupel's in the shotgun. 2 seconds, 1 second. He gets the snap off in time. Throws a short pass. Deflected. And, that was close. Aaron Hunt deflected that pass straight up in the air and is almost picked off for about a 1-yard touchdown run. So that was a snafu deal indeed, those 3 plays. Started at the 8, end at the 8, and almost had a pass interception. Wow, that was dangerous, Merv.
Really is. It's dangerous right here, too, to kick to this guy because he's had such tremendous success returning punts this year.
Welker is deep, the Heritage Hall youngster playing for Texas Tech. Jeff Ferguson from Broken Arrow, the good kicker for Oklahoma. He's with the wind here. That's the good news. We had 9:56 to go in the fourth period. The Sooners dominated the third period, but only put 1 touchdown on the board. Tech has a field goal to show for their efforts here in the second half, and they only
get called for too long.
There's the snap, just got it off, and here's the kick. The line drive kick, and Welker comes up to take it at the Oklahoma 46 to the 40, goes to the sideline-yard line. Only a 38-yard kick. Sooners need a better one than that. About a 6-yard return, and tackled by Ben Painter, the deep snapper from Stillwell, Oklahoma. So Texas Tech, again, with excellent field position. They have it at the Oklahoma 40, first down and 10 yards to go. While the Sooners dominated the third period, Tech so far has dominated the fourth period.
Well, they really have. The Sooners have created their own problems here with the interception off return, and they really have kind of like they've done all day. They're just asking an awful lot out of this defense.
Tech has three wide receivers left and one to the right. Kingsbury is in the shotgun formation, and to his left is Shad Williams. Here's the snap to Kingsbury. He's being rushed. He shows a screen pass, and it's either caught for no gain and a flag. Let's see. Shad Williams was the lad for whom the pass was intended.
They may call that on Torrance. That's a poor call because Shad Williams could be trying to block him.
Let's see what they call this. This crew is the flag crew, I guarantee you. Now they're coming over to explain things to Coach Stoops. And it's holding against Oklahoma. That's the call. Boy, what a call. Shad Williams was in the – that's who the pass was intended for. I guess they rule that it was held before the pass got there. I assume that's what they're saying. Tenth penalty for, what, 93 yards? That's what Terry McLemore tells us. The ball is down at the 30 now, and that's their 17th first down at the Oklahoma 30. Holding on Oklahoma. Fourth first down by Penley. From the 30, shotgun formation. Kingsbury gets the snap, hands the ball off. Easterling over the right tackle. Jumps one tackler, gets the 26 maybe. Easterling, a three-year letterman from Crowley, Texas. 23-5-11-201 senior. That's his first carry of the day, and he got maybe short of that 26. Put it at the 27. 3 yards picked up. Second down, 7. For Tech at the Oklahoma 27, no huddle. Brandon Everidge in, replacing Kalmus, extra defensive back from the Oklahoma 27. Welker is in motion toward the formation. Now he stops. Here is the snap to Kingsbury. Back to pass. He's being rushed out of the pack. He throws a pass caught at the 27-yard line by Welker, but he's dumped easily by Roy Williams, who shoved him backwards, so there was no gain. Completed a pass for no gain. It's third down, 7. Barry Holloman, who's had a great day defensively, put some pressure on the quarterback. Though they give him a good spot. They say forward progress was to a yard gain. Well, and it's 8:32 in the clock running to go in the fourth period. Two wide receivers to both sides. Third down play and 6. On third down conversions, 2 of 15 for Texas Tech. Snap to Kingsbury. He'll run with it. Draw play. He's down. He has a first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. Hit by Thatcher. There's a gaping hole over the right side as he got the snap from the shotgun and looked for 1 second, then took off to his right. Good hole, and he got 7 yards and first down number 18. Second in this drive, if you want to call it that. First one was by the penalty, and it's to the Oklahoma 19-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Clock running with 8:13 to go, fourth period. Three wide receivers left and one to the right. That's Tim Baker wide to the right side. Welker and two others are to the left side. Under center goes Kingsbury. Maybe changing the play at the 19. I-backs out of there, back into the shotgun. Waiting for snap from Cecil. It's a high snap. He gets it, hands the ball off, and that's Shad Williams. He gets a yard or two down close to the 15, actually, before J.T. Thatcher tackles him. So it'll be, depends on where they spot it, probably around the 15, but 15.
High snap probably helped that play. Caused the defense to react maybe a little improperly and actually made it a better play.
Now here's King Scoville in, a wide receiver. We have a shotgun formation from the 15-yard line in Sooner territory. Snap to Kingsbury. He looks. He's still looking. He fires. And it's caught touchdown. For a touchdown for Texas Tech. Went through Derek Strait's hands into the hands of Tim Baker. So that's a 15-yard touchdown pass to Baker. But, Merv, you just can't keep playing the game down in deep Oklahoma territory for one reason or another and hold him out forever. And that's what happened there.
Wow, we didn't have a real good play on the ball then. I think the play that hurt him even worse was the quarterback scrambling for a first down a while ago on long yardage. You know, we talked about that possibility. I'm really surprised they're not going for two here.
Baker's first touchdown. Oh, here's, his first touchdown of the year, I believe. Here's a snap. The ball is low. The kick is by Burkholz through the uprights. Timeout. And with 7:13 to go, fourth period, 21-12 is the score. 13, out here. 21-13 on the board. And we'll be back after this. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. Clinton Greathouse will be kicking off into the wind. Iowa State beat Kansas today, 38-17. Not on the flashed on the board here. had one upset as Mississippi State. Didn't you say Murr was beaten by?
They showed Arkansas beating them 17-10.
K-State beat Missouri 28-24. That clinches the North Division for them. Here's the kickoff, end over end, rather short kick. Thatcher at the 15, to the 20, to his left of the 25, bumps into a player and is brought down at the 29 or 30, about a 14-yard return. And the Sooners' offense needs to get geared up here from their own 29-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Last time the Sooners had it, they had three plays, none of which were any good, and they ended up right where they started and had to punt it away. Crowd cheers them on as the offense comes out. Josh Norman's in there, Quentin Griffin, of course, Josh Heupel, Fagan, and Wolfolk. Sooners line up ready to go from their own 29-yard line, leading 21-13. Norman in motion from slot left to the right. That puts three wide receivers to the right side. Heupel's back to pass, throws, caught by Fagan at the 33. Tackle right there at the 33. 4 yards picked up, brought down by Lawrence Flugens. We haven't called his number too much, his second. Her second reception there for 55 yards. But Flugens, who leads the conference in tackles, 143, that's only his second tackle of the day. Ball at the 33 in Oklahoma territory, 6 yards to go at the 33 in Sooner territory. 6:33 to go, fourth period. Bubba Burcham will center it back on the shotgun to Josh Heupel. Heupel backs up, he looks left, he pump fakes, he throws. It's intended for Wolfolk, incomplete. We didn't mention earlier, obviously, if you live in the area, Central Time Zone, it's getting dark, and the lights have been on for some time here. And, of course, the lights are terrific here at Owen Field. 3 of 9 on third down conversions from the 33. It is 3rd and 6. Big play, Merv, right here.
Yeah, it really is. It really is. It's going to be interesting to see whether Tech defends or blitz. I think that certainly they're going to make it look like they're blitzing. I'm not sure they are.
Three wide receivers left, one to the right. Heupel in the shotgun. They back out of there. Blitzing from the corner. Pass caught, first down by Wolfolk at the 41 or 2. And he goes out of bounds on the far side. That's a perfect pass by Heupel. And Wolfolk made a fine catch at the 40 and went to the 42. Derek Riggs pushed him out of bounds. So there's a big play, 9 yards picked up, and the Sooners have their first down of the fourth period, and it's their 17th in the ball game. Ball at the 42-yard line, Sooner into the field. On either side of quarterback Josh Heupel, who's in the shotgun. Here's the handoff. Griffin looks for a hole, cuts over the left side, gets across the 45 to the 46. So he picks up 4 on the play. Quentin Griffin is carried today. 11 carries for 47 yards. And Quentin Griffin coming into the game as the leading rusher with 530 yards and 15 touchdowns. Texas Tech has used all their timeouts, and that could be a key. 5:48 to go. Three wide receivers left, one tied to the right, Matt Anderson to the right. Josh Heupel from the shotgun looks to pass, fires it. Looks like it may have been caught at the midfield stripe by Wolfolk, but he had to leave his feet to make the catch. So it's a 4-yard pickup to the midfield stripe, but it's a 3rd and 2 then from that point. And the clock continues to run with 5:25, not 5:24 to go in the fourth period.
Big play right here, Bob. Big play right here.
Second time in this drive that they've gone to third down play. Wolfolk and Josh Norman left. Matt Anderson and Savage right. Or is that Fagan right rather than Savage? In motion, Josh Norman from left to right. Josh Heupel back to pass. Heupel throws a pass, caught for the first down to 44. Fagan down to the 40-yard line in Tech territory. Almost 11 yards on the play from the 50 down to the 40. That was a great decision by Heupel. He could have run for it and maybe gotten the first down. He only needed a couple of yards, but he saw Fagan and fired it to him in a safe pass. And Fagan caught it and got to the 40. First down number 18. Second of this drive, and the ball is at the Tech 40-yard line.
A mature quarterback with Josh's poise can do things like that. Obviously, we're sitting here both hoping he would run, but he was able to get about 7 or 8, 10 more yards just by doing what he did. He had confidence in Fagan to do it.
Under center is Heupel. Quentin Wright needs a block, doesn't get it, but gets to the 36. And stayed in bounds, Paul McClendon on the tackle, pick up a 4. He was brought down by So it's a 4:16 to go fourth period, 21-13 the score. Sooners on top. And this drive started at their own 29. They picked up two first downs. They've run seven plays, and that's the drive you needed, Mother.
Yeah, it really is. We got to hope we can see them make at least one more first down here, Bob. I think it would put them in decent shape if they can.
Three wide receivers left, one to the right. Ball at the 36 in Texas Tech territory. They're showing blitz. 11 men within 3 yards of line of scrimmage. Now they back out of there. Heupel looks to his left. Throws a pass, caught at the 30-yard line. Fagan to the 25, Fagan to the 24-yard line. The go-to man is Curtis Fagan. And he got 12 on that play from the 36 to the 24 in Tech territory. First down number 19 in the third in this drive. Boy, he's really, really firing those balls in there. They're down the middle.
Yeah, they really are. They back early in the game, they hit some of those hooks and stop routes where the receiver goes down 8 to 10, 12 yards and just turns around and he puts it in there. That's his own defense type of route, obviously, and Josh can put it on you pretty good.
Now it's Luttrell in there at left half back and Quiffin at right half back, and the shotgun is Heupel, first and 10 from the Texas Tech 24-yard line. Man in motion, his left to right, handoff to Griffin, going to his left, cuts at the 18, gets to the 17-yard line. To the 22. That was 5 yards farther downfield. As Kevin Curtis, the strong safety, makes the stop at the 22. From the 24 down to the 22. Inside 3 minutes as Josh Norman checks aboard, replacing Seth Luttrell. 10th play of the drive. And 4.5 minutes they've held on to the football, Merv.
That's good, and it's good to Tech's out of timeouts. We need another first down, Bob. I don't want to try to kick another field goal after the bad experience of that first one.
From the 22, needing to get pulls right. The blitz is on. Heupel fires a pass. Caught by Norman at the 19 and out of bounds. That stops the clock at the 18 is where he, but it's close to a first down. Only 4 yards to go. It'll be third and 4 from the 18. Though they had the full blitz on, but Heupel was tough hanging in there and threw a fine pass.
Couldn't block them all, and he had to throw off of one of them, and he did. Unfortunately, it was a pass that wouldn't stop the clock.
The ball is at the 18. 4 yards picked up, as we called it. Third down, 4 at the 18, and Luttrell is back in there. 5 of 11 on third down conversions. Offset eye formation. Heupel under center. Griffin behind him, and Seth Luttrell offset. Looks like they're going to blitz. They certainly are up in the line of scrimmage. And now Heupel calls a timeout. He was trying to draw him offsides, perhaps. We'll take a break. 2:29 to go. 21-13, the Sooners lead Texas Tech. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. All right, we have Heupel under center. Twin backs, Griffin and Seth Luttrell from the 18-yard line. They fake, and Heupel bootlegs, passes, caught at the 10-yard line by Matt Anderson, butts his way across the 5 to the 4, maybe even the 3. Boy, I tell you, that Matt Anderson is tough to get down.
Great call.
And it was a bootleg. The Sooners have not run that play that often this year,
Murph. No, they really haven't. It's been effective when they run it, but they and maybe that's the way to do it. Don't use it all that much with Josh. He's not really a threat to want to run the ball, and maybe that's the way to use it, Bob, just sparingly.
Well, boy, that worked beautifully. It went from the 18 down to the 4, but actually it's inside the 4. That's the fourth first down in this drive. They call it the Tech 4-yard line. First down goal to go on the clock at 2:21, and they will start the clock. There it is, as they set the chain for the first and goal. Well, this drive started at the 29, and the Sooners have moved it all the way down to the 4-yard line in Tech territory. 12th play of this drive. Ironically, their last touchdown drive in the second period, or the one before this, was started at the 29. The inside 2 minutes when he snaps it from the 4-yard line, a shotgun. Side of the 2 to the 1, touchdown Oklahoma! What a great drive when the Sooners really needed it. 71 yards on the drive. 16th touchdown for Quentin Griffin. Great blocking over the right side. Mike Skinner, Kempenick, and Bubba Burcham. Well, that was something.
Well, it was really something, Bob, in that that's the best by far the offense has looked all day, maybe the last 2 weeks. They really looked like a team on a mission right there, and they executed so well, and Josh threw some critical, critical passes. What did they have, 4 third down conversions?
They did. Three third down conversions.
And really made some big plays. We got some foolish people throwing oranges out here, and we don't need a penalty on this kickoff, but I guess fans are going to have to do a few things.
12 plays, 71 yards, took 5:20 off the clock, and boy, that's a key. And now it will be the extra point attempt coming up by Tim Duncan at the south end zone. Sooners lead 27-13 with 1:53 to go in the fourth period. That was just a beautiful drive executed by the entire offense.
Key catches, pressure catches. Of course, Josh, what can you say with some of those throws he made and some good 4- and 5-yard runs.
Right. And Quentin Griffin very determined there on that 4-yard touchdown run. Here we go, the extra point. Ball is down. Kick is in the air, and it's blocked. First time today he's missed an extra point. Ball is on the ground, and Roger Steffen picked it up, was running forward trying to get in for the two-point conversion. So that breaks the string of 54 in a row for Tim Duncan. We'll take a break here with 1:53 to go. It's 27-13 Sooners. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network. It booms this one downfield, and it goes into the end zone. It'll be allowed to roll dead and be brought out to the 20. So Texas Tech will have it first and 10 from their own 20-yard line with a minute 53 to go. Kansas State beat Missouri today. So Lazatich, the fullback for K-State in the Oklahoma game, suffered a concussion in that game when they played back on October 14th. And I believe that was the date of it. At any rate, yes, it was October 14th. And Lazatich had his career come to an end. He's okay, nothing serious, but they advised him not to play football anymore. All right, Texas Tech from the 20, first and 10. Kingsbury in the shotgun. The blitz is on. They rush him, and they sack him. Torrance Marshall got to him first, I believe. It'll be at the put the progress to the 10 or 11.
That's
Torrance Marshall gets credit.
Hurts you when you have no timeouts left in a hurry-up situation. A sack or a short pass where you tackle for no gain is almost a wasted play.
Second and 19 from the 11. Lost 10, a minute 29 to go in the fourth period. Sooners lead 27-13. Three wide receivers left and one to the right. Kingsbury, quick pass to Welker. It's caught at the 15 and the 20. Cuts up the sideline. Boy, he is slippery, and he gets all the way up to the 26-yard line. Michael Thompson ran him out at the Oklahoma 26. 15 yards picked up at the 19. His eighth catch of the day, so it's third and 4. He has 85 yards total.
A great opportunity for the Sooners to intercept one right here. There's no, you know, question as to what Tech's going to have to do.
From the 26, third down, 4 yards to go. Third down conversions. 3 of 15. Kingsbury, quick pass, caught at the 26. Sean Williams retreats, and he may get the first down. I believe he does. He retreated behind the first down marker to get some running room, and then Roy Williams hit him, and he gets the first down at the 31. But now we have 1:07, and the clock stopped till they move the chain. As Texas Tech has the ball thrown 31, first down and 10 yards to go. Sean Williams, 8th reception of the day. Here's the snap. Kingsbury, Sooners blitzing. They threw it away, and Ante Jones put plenty of pressure on. Second down, 10 from the 31. 55 seconds to go. If not, we hope you'll join us along the Sooner Network. And remember, in Oklahoma City tonight only, it's on KRXO as the Sooner women are playing, and they've split, the Oklahoma City station has split their broadcast. So we're joining us for that broadcast, Oklahoma against LaSalle, and airtime a quarter till 8 for the pregame show. Here's the snap back to Kingsbury. Good protection. Throws up the middle. Caught at the 46 in Tech territory and down almost immediately. That was Darryl Jones from Lubbock Coronado High School, and it's first down as the gain goes for 16 yards. The 20th first down for Texas Tech. Oklahoma also has 20 first downs. And we have now 47 ticks of the clock to go in the fourth period. Sooners leading 27-13. Three-man rush. Two linebackers are in there, but they back away from there as Kingsbury gets the snap. Good protection. Throws a pass. It's Doris dropped it. Juggle it and drop the ball. Incomplete.
Not a great throw. He's thrown that slant play behind him a couple of times, and that's an extremely difficult catch, Bob. You're flying inside so fast, you just got no time to adjust to the throw.
So Kingsbury has 283 yards passing, 37 of 57. Most yardage the Sooners have given up all year. Kingsbury back to pass, throws in the flat, caught and out of bounds. Tim Baker at the 49, gained only 2. 2-yard pass play. Laterally, it was about a 15-yard pass. It was the hash mark on the near side, clear over to the far sideline, but he gained a couple, maybe 3.
30 seconds to go in this game.
That does allow you to stop the clock, but at this stage of the game, it really 2 yards didn't help you a whole lot.
Third down, and let's call it 8 yards to go. Kingsbury in the shotgun, three wide receivers left, one to the right. Passes, caught behind the line. This Francis gets by one tackler, and then Brandon Everidge ends it, fumbles, and I believe he was down. Knee was down at the 48 in Sooner territory. Fourth down play and five, and that'll probably be it as the clock is running.
Two senior defensive backs in there, Bob, but Shoulders, Marvin Shoulders, and Jackson got a chance to play there on the last couple of plays.
Okay, great. Good to mention their name. As the clock is running down, 2 seconds, 1 second, and has a flag down. We got 1 second to go. And let's see what they do here.
Unfortunately. I mean, you know, why do people do that, Bob?
I don't know. They're excited.
They're obviously Sooner fans. Well, you know, throw them back over the back of the stadium or somewhere. Throw them down in the end zone where nobody's at.
Ball is at the 33 with 1 second to go. And
I don't blame him.
The orange may have hit the referee. That's why he called the flag.
You know, if they throw a touchdown pass here, the guy that threw that's probably going to not be sick, but he ought to be. We added some time to the clock, too, Bob.
And it's 6 seconds. Okay, we're set to go as Texas Tech now has the ball at the 33, their 21st first down at the Oklahoma 33. Here's Kingsbury back for the last play of the game, probably. Fires a short pass, caught at the 30. The 25, Ashad Williams to the 20, gets by a tackler, then is stuck hard. And the game's over. Brandon Everidge makes the stop, and the game ends. Oklahoma beats Texas Tech by a score of 27-13. They're 10-0, and that clinches the South, and four oranges pour on the field. And we have the Big 12 South Championship banners being placed up down here, Murr. Looks to be like.
Well, the balloons are having a little trouble getting off the ground. I hope that's no indication of anything other than that.
Well, that's fantastic, I'll tell you. The first
Maybe
time
they're
ever.
Just supposed to support that banner and not fly away with it. I guess I'm.
I think they are just supposed to keep it raised. And the Sooners win. The Big 12 South moved to the Big 12 Championship game December 2nd against K-State, who won the North. Our final score, Oklahoma 27, Texas Tech 13. We'll be back with a wrap-up show, including an interview with Coach Bob Stoops and some Sooner players. This is the Oklahoma Sooner Network.